The views and opinions expressed on any program are those of the persons appearing on the program and do not necessarily reflect the views and opinions of the New Media Factory. Some programs on this network might include strong images and language and may not be suitable for all audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.
Just when I thought I was out, they pulled me back in.
The biggest, most outrageous online show in Philippine history.
20 million fucking downloads.
Interactive in 35 countries. Mo is back with a vengeance in season 2. Bigger, better, badder.
Let's start off with an international call. Yesterday we took a call from India. Tonight it's Canada.
Nice.
Let's go to Ireland. Where in Ireland are you?
Well, I'm in Dublin.
Some people say that I'm a bad guy. They may be right.
Let's go to Afghanistan. Holy shit, are you fucking really in Afghanistan?
Yeah, man, what's up?
Florida, what's up?
I just found your show today, and I think it's great.
Live from Hollywood and at the Beyond the Box Studios in One Rockwell, Makati, it's Good Times with Mo, the podcast, season 2, the Bigger, Better, Badder podcast. Your questions about love, life, sex,
and more sex
are all answered and occasionally made fun of here. And now, the man who loves women and dudes, but not in the same way. The Philippine genius, DJ Mo Twister.
Podcast being brought to you by Globe. And of course, I am not Mo Twister again. I am Kat Alano. And joining me this evening is the lovely Max Eigenmann, who was here the other day with Carla Saldran.
Yes, I was. Hi, Kat. Hi, guys.
How are you doing? And she was so awesome the other day. We decided to bring her back and join me naman today. And we're going to have a stab
at... I'm excited for this one.
At fixing your problems. That's what we're going to do today. Now, for those of you who are probably abroad and maybe you've never heard of Max, Max is pretty much in the Philippines considered showbiz royalty, pretty much, right? Because her family is, you are, am I correct, like third generation showbiz, what do you call it? Showbiz royalty. That's what it's called. Like, if you've been in the industry that long, you're a third generation showbiz person. That's what you call it. So tell us a little bit about your family for everybody out there who hasn't heard about your family, the Eigenmanns, who are everywhere.
Okay. Well, third generation, meaning the business as in where all of us are in. My grandparents started with it, which is Rosemary Hill and Eddie Mesa.
Mm-hmm.
And they had four kids, yep. Three of which entered show business, which is Tita Cherie, mm-hmm. Tita Mike, and my dad, mm-hmm. Mark Hill.
Mm-hmm.
And we're 12 cousins.
Yep.
I think seven of us are in the industry.
Dang, that's a lot of you guys in the industry. I mean, you know, how does it work? Do you guys ever get competitive with each other? I mean, do you ever compete for jobs with any of your
cousins? Actually,
you
know, that's a really awesome thing to ask because we get asked that a lot.
Yeah.
And at the end of the day, when we're together, we actually never talk about work.
Okay.
And when we actually get projects together, it's like extra fun. We're like, yeah, really? Oh my God.
That's like, cool, right? It's just like hanging out with your family, but on set. Like, yes. Hey guys, let's mess around for a second. What's happening? Let's work, but let's do it at home. Anyway, that must be really cool. And it must be cool because, you know, in show business, you encounter a lot of problems. I mean, there are a lot of bad things that happen in showbiz as well as good things. The amazing things, of course, outweigh the bad things. But there are a lot of bad things. So it must be nice to have family members who can really relate to what you're going through and be able to give you advice and, you know, guide you through
and
things.
Laugh about it at the same time.
Laugh
because
about
a lot
it.
Of the shit, I love that I can say that. Can I just say that? Yeah, I love that I can say shit. A lot of the shit that goes
shit.
On, like, you know, like, we can all laugh about it together. And that's what's awesome about it. And we kind of just see the more fun part of it all than being too serious about it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But that's good because then you're kind of living your life and you're doing what you love and you have a nice life. You know, I don't think it should be stressful at all when you're doing
it's
what you love, right?
I love it. I love my job.
Right. It's an awesome good thing. And you are a mom. You have two sons,
two kids,
right? And how old are they now?
My older one just turned 7 and then my second one is turning 2 in a couple of weeks. May 5, Cinco de Mayo.
Awesome. Yeah. Yes, two boys. Strapping young lads.
I love it. Oh my God. Two boys are the best.
Awesome. That
I'm
sounds like
to have
a lot
a girl.
Of fun. Really?
Yeah.
I'm but excited about
if
having
If you
a girl.
Had kids, would you prefer a girl or a boy?
I really don't know. I don't have any kids, so...
No, but
I, you
if
know.
You had... Like, I mean, if just thinking about it.
If you could... I don't know. Can you ever really tell if you want boys or girls or if you'd
you
like
know,
to
before,
have boys or girls until
I mean,
you have them?
I never thought that I would have kids really early.
Yeah.
which I did. But I'm not going to pretend about the fact that when I was younger, I would fantasize about, because I was making up names and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And all the names that I had were all for girls.
Yeah.
And I thought that I really wanted a girl. But now that I have two boys, I'm just like, I'm scared to have a girl.
Really?
Having boys.
Why is that?
They're so good in yosa to the mom.
Ah. Because the girls are like daddy's girls. So it's going to be a little different. Oh, I get you. I get you. All right. Well, see, me and Max haven't caught up in a little while. So we're catching up with you guys. And you guys get to know her a little bit. Plus, Max is awesome at giving advice. So if you guys want to call us up and give us your problems so we can fix them. She has a lot of life experience and she's a mom, so you know she deals with problems all the time because she has kids and you are like our big kids. So we're going to take care of you today. If you want to call us up, 478-7954 or 0927-36004. Is that an 8? I think it was
it's an 8.
There you go. Yeah. 485. There you go. So 0927-360-0485. Also, if you want to Skype us, it's the Skype name is The Good Times Podcast. And if you are too cheap to call us yourself, you can text us and we will call for you. Now, we have a couple of callers on the line. Max, are you ready to take some interesting calls today? Cool.
Thank
Let's
you,
start with, we have...
TJ.
Yeah, TJ, 21 years old in Paranaque. TJ, are you there?
Yeah, hello, yes.
Hi, TJ.
Hi, hello, hi, yes. TJ.
Hey, guys. Hey, Mo. I'm a big fan.
Mo's not here, sweetie. It's Kat Alano.
Yeah, TJ, Mo's not here today. I'm Kat Alano, and I'm filling in for him. And this is Max Eigenmann, and she's super awesome. So is that okay with you?
I'm sorry.
Mo's not here tonight, sweetie. It's Kat Alano and me, Max Eigenmann. What's up?
Hey.
Are you disappointed that Mo's not here?
It's like, oh, damn, I want to hang up the phone now.
Wouldn't you rather talk to two chicks?
Are you gay?
Is that what you're asking for most specifically? Hello?
TJ? Did he totally hang up? Oh my god, he totally hung up when I said he
asked. Because Mo isn't
here.
What the
TJ?
Hell? I'm offended.
Hello? Hi, TJ. We can kind of hear you. Did you swallow your phone? Stick it up your butt to prove a point?
But we didn't get to see it, so what the hell?
Oh,
there's no
work.
Point proving
oh,
there.
Oh, so he's hiding from his boss right now. His boss just walked by, and he's sitting on his phone, so we're actually listening to his butt. Hello, TJ's butt. How
Did
are you
doing? Did he just butt dial us by...
Right?
On purpose?
I don't know.
He butt dialed us on purpose, dude.
His boss is walking past now, so he's put his phone under his butt.
So that... Okay.
So we're having a conversation with his butt. Now, if you were actually talking to a butt, what would you say?
Does that make sense?
Yeah.
It was actually something
down
naughty.
To his level.
I actually,
and, you know.
I actually was trying to say something naughty, but...
It came out as a fart?
I'm sure the butt would understand me.
Brain
right?
fart. That's what you call a brain
oh
fart.
God,
do we
I
still have
you.
TJ on the line?
I freaking love this chick.
Is he still
I thought
there?
I was the only one who knew that those two words. Brain farts.
Okay, let's go to our next caller for now. TJ, I don't know what you're doing, but if you're sitting on your phone, we can't talk to your butt for too long. We're going to go to the next caller, who is Roka, 35 years old from Dubai. Who called us last night, right? Roka, are you there?
Hello.
Hi, Roka. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you guys? Me again. Sorry.
No. Thank you so much for calling us again. I'd like you to meet my friend Max.
Hi, Roka.
Hi, Maxine. How are you?
Hey, you called me with my whole name. What's up?
So, Roka, what can we do for you today? What's happening?
Before that, you guys... Look gorgeous, actually.
Thank you.
Thank you
so much. Oh, flattery will get you everywhere. Look at that. We're both like listening and we're like, oh.
What's up, y'all?
So sweet, Roka. You're awesome. Caught us off guard.
No,
all right. So what's going on, Roka? What's happening?
Well, this is something different, actually, based on what we discussed yesterday.
Okay, wait, okay. So, Roka, you have to fill in all the listeners who are listening today who haven't spoken to you before, and Max as well, on your situation, even if it's just a brief summary of what we were talking about before. Give her a little bit of a lowdown on what's happening in your life.
Okay. Again and again. Anyways, I was married and... separated for 3 years now.
Okay.
Been trying to work on annulment, and then, but my question right now is really different from what we're talking previously.
Okay, so what is your question today, Roka?
Okay. All right. There's a girl I really like, and I want to create. Yep.
Okay. Right. And you want to what? Yeah.
I want to create a positive impact on her.
Okay.
What, you know, what kinds of gifts would be appropriate?
Gifts? Well, I don't know about gifts right
not
away.
Yet,
I mean,
right? Not yet. Yeah. No gifts yet. I think that would be really creepy. If you don't let her know yet in advance, you know, like...
Wait. How long have you known this girl, Rocco?
We've been casually friends back home, actually.
Okay.
All right. So, but we just get to know better here.
Okay. So how long have you known her? Like a couple of years, couple of months, couple of days, couple of minutes? What are you talking about?
Here, I've been like months or
for. So you've already been talking for a couple of months. So she knows. Yes. Does she know that you have feelings for her?
Kinda, yep.
She does know. You told her, or she just guessed?
I told her.
Okay, so how did she react when you told her that you had feelings for her?
Surprised a little bit, and. Well, she put me on a friend zone, actually.
She put you in the friend zone.
Yeah. Oh. We've been discussing it with Carlos before.
Okay. Well, if she's kind of put you in the friend zone, are you hoping to come out of the friend zone by buying her nice gifts and stuff? Is that what you're trying to do?
No, not really, because it's her birthday next week, so I'm just like thinking of...
Okay,
yeah.
So you just want to know what kind of a gift would be suitable for her. Well, I mean, what kind of a person is she? Is she is she funky? Is she kind of conservative? Is she, I mean, what kind of a chick is she?
A bit funky.
A bit funky, like not smelly armpits, but, you know, like a little bit crazy, a little bit quirky, a little bit strange, a little bit colorful, that kind of funky?
Yeah, because she's like more into like music, you know.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Well, I don't know. What do you think would be a good idea for a birthday present? You don't want to seem
for a
like
girl who's into
creepy,
music.
But
no
you want a
birthday.
You want to give her a good thing.
How old is this girl?
She's around 26.
26.
Okay. And what is she like? I mean what things does she like? Do you ever notice that she needs anything or wants anything? Does she ever mention like, oh, you know, I'd really like to do this or I really like some of that? Has she ever said anything like that? Because the thing that I think is most awesome when guy gives you a gift is when he's really thought about it and
yes.
he's paid
when
attention.
When he's observed something that you wouldn't think that he was actually observing about
yeah.
you.
Yeah,
that
absolutely.
Would be something cool. Have you observed anything about her that...
Yeah, well, when... Yeah, I remember one time when we were in a mall. She was interested in this one perfume, so I'm not sure if that will work.
Why not?
But that's consumable, isn't it? Is that fine?
It's a bit too personal, don't you think?
Well, if she said that she liked it, I mean,
yeah, she liked
I wouldn't
it.
Mind if
actually.
Somebody bought me a perfume that they knew I liked. I mean, if you said that too, if you're like, yeah, I remember you were saying that you liked this perfume, so I got it for you for your birthday. I don't. That's not creepy
yeah,
or anything,
that's,
right?
That's
it's kind of nice, right?
That's
it's
true,
like,
that's true.
That's actually a really good tip for all guys out there who are watching right now or do watch this. If you pay attention to the girl that you like, and you... watch the things that she picks up in the store or looks at. I mean, I know guys hate going shopping with girls.
True,
I know it's
but if you pay a little more attention,
yeah,
you wouldn't have this problem.
Right?
You would know what to get.
Exactly. Paying a little bit of attention really counts because when a girl knows that you put some thought into something and you were paying attention and you were listening to what she was saying and you weren't just kind of...
staring at her boobs.
Yeah, the whole time that you were shopping. Then, you know, girls really, really appreciate that. And it kind of wins you points in your little heart thing. You
that's
know what
true.
I mean? It's like, yeah. Oh, I love you a little bit more. You know, that's always a bonus point yeah. for guys. So that's a good thing.
And it makes them remember you more.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, the thing is, though, if you don't want to be too personal, I mean, are you guys still friends after you told her that you had feelings for her? Or did she get, like, weird and not talk to you that much anymore?
Yeah, we're still friends, actually.
So you guys are totally okay? Like, there's no awkwardness or anything like that?
Before, there is a little bit.
But after you told her, is there still any awkwardness?
After, we've been working out to eliminate the awkwardness, actually.
Ooh, see, that's what I'm a little worried about, is whether or not perfume may be a little personal, because you did just tell her that you love her, and she might think that by you buying her the perfume, you're trying to win her heart over. Yes. And you don't want to go down there because it might be a little too much. Well, so I guess if you were to go a little impersonal on it and not too kind of like, hey, look, I've been watching you. This is what I got you because this is what you're looking
at. If she likes music, get her a great pair of earphones. Marshalls are great.
Yes. Right? Get her a great pair of earphones. If she does like music, do that. That's always a safe option.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
Good idea.
Not that creepy, but it's pretty cool, because if she likes music that much, then she must like listening to music, obviously. Exactly. So get her a great pair of headphones or earphones.
Not too trying hard, because if like I'm thinking about also a phone, but like it looks
oh,
like
oh no
yeah
try,
yeah
that,
that's
trying
like
hard.
A phone?
No, not a phone. Come on, yo.
No. That's a really bad idea. One tip as well for guys. I mean, even if you have a lot of money and stuff, if you...
Don't ever get a girl a phone.
Yeah, it says commitment all over the place.
And like, I want to control you.
Right? It's like a...
It's like, why are you getting me a phone?
What's the equivalent? Like, when do guys freak out? When a girl asks to meet his mother?
Yes.
Giving a girl a phone.
Like, I want to meet your mom.
Right? Giving a girl a phone is like a girl asking you to meet your mom. That's how
true.
Girls freak out.
Seriously.
You know, a guy gives you a really expensive thing and it's like they expect you to have sex with them.
Exactly.
That's
it's like, you want to own me? Oh my God, it's Vicky, like, I can't accept this.
Don't do it. So don't ever do it.
But if it's, you know, a great pair of headphones or earphones, you mentioned that she likes music, right?
Yeah.
So I think that would be a safe choice if you don't want to come out too creepy or come out too like, I want you.
Yeah. I love you.
It's kind of like a friendly thing, but a thoughtful thing at the same time, because you paid attention to the fact that she likes music. So it's kind of like a win-win situation for me.
I agree. I completely agree with Max. I think it's a really good idea. Buy her a set of headphones.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, Beats headphones.
Yes.
Why not?
Beats expensive.
Well, you wanted to buy her a phone. How much was the phone going to be? Like 200 pesos or something? Seriously, perfume, a phone, or headphones. I think you can do headphones if you could do perfume and a phone.
Yes, that's true.
Okay. Perfume is quite... It's consumables. Is that all right?
Consumables?
Like, I mean, yeah, it will run out like for a month or maybe weeks, right?
What kind of consumables?
Like, I mean the perfume is like... It will just be run out after a few weeks of use, right?
Yeah.
So.
Exactly. So you kind of answered your own question, because headphones, earphones, she'll remember you for a long time until it stops working.
Yeah.
Right?
Well, everything, all of those things are going to disappear unless you get a tattoo of her face on your back, which is a really
That's
bad
true.
Idea. Don't ever do that. So
please don't ever do that. Like, oh, my God.
Everything is going to break or run out and all that stuff. So don't do anything permanent, bro. You just want to make her happy on her birthday. Okay?
Okay, guys. Thank you so much for that.
All right, Rogan, thanks so much for calling us up. Good luck, okay? And I hope she really likes the gift, okay?
Have a good evening, everyone.
No, you know what, though? There are two people in the world who have my face tattooed to their body.
Are you shitting me?
No, I'm really serious.
No,
when I used to do the radio show.
Did one of them actually date you? Did any of them date
you? No. Total strangers. Like, when we were doing the radio show before, we got sponsors to come in and tattoo people for free if they were going to get... one guy got scratch marks butt tattooed. Scratch marks child face, like scratch marks 11-year-old face tattooed to his butt. And then two guys had my face tattooed to their backs, to their shoulder. And so it's
And how do
cool.
you feel about that? I would like to know.
You know, it was a little weird at first, but it's kind of cool to be able to say that. You know what I mean? How many people, apart from like Justin Bieber or like Michael Jackson, can really say that somebody has their face tattooed to somebody? And it's like...
Or the cast of Twilight, because I saw in this magazine one time that this woman really, really liked one of the movies in the trilogy.
Yep.
That she had a tattoo of the DVD poster.
Yep.
Of like what's his face? The guy who plays the wolf.
Oh,
was it
Jake?
Yeah,
Jacob.
Jake. Bella. Okay, I do watch it. I know the cast. Jacob, Bella, and Edward.
She's like, yeah, yeah, that what's his name? That wolf guy.
I do watch it, you guys.
I don't remember.
You have to forgive me. But she had the whole thing tattooed there, even with the trees and stuff. And yeah, like, yeah. I love this particular movie. Oh, what the fuck, right?
Seriously, I don't know if I'd get anybody's face tattooed.
I would rather see your face tattooed than somebody else.
It is honestly a cool fact. So, you know, we got to dupe some people into getting my face tattooed to this. So that's always awesome. Anyway, we're going to take another call right now. We have another call from, is TJ back? Is he still talking to his butt? Okay, John, 22 years old from Quezon City. John, are you there?
Hello.
Hi, John.
Hi.
Hi. Hi. How are you? Oh,
he's happy.
Hello. Yeah.
Yeah? Did you just call us to let us listen to your dogs barking? I mean, it's generous of you, but do you have a problem?
Yeah, I'm done. And it's just my screen name.
What, sorry?
Yeah, I'm John.
Yes. We established that point.
Yeah.
Would you like us to spell it for you?
I have a situation here.
Oh, okay. Is it an emergency?
I'm gay.
You're gay?
Yeah.
Okay.
Uh-huh. And I have a situation here because I have an affair with a 50-year-old plus guy.
Whoa!
With this 50-year-old what?
50-year-old?
Yeah.
With this 50-year-old guy.
Okay. I thought you said 15 for a second. I was going to say, a different story here, okay? That is a situation. We need to take care of this. But okay, so you're having an affair with a 50-year-old guy.
Yeah, and exactly we have 30 years of gap. I'm 22 and he's 52.
Okay.
Yeah, and the problem here is that I am afraid of losing him because of this Sasha Padilla thing.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Wow. So, you're 22 years old and you're dating a 52-year-old gay man.
Yeah, we have a relationship.
Okay.
So you've been dating for how long?
2 years.
Two years?
Oh, wow, okay. It's been a good long time. You guys are there. And so, your concern is that you're going to lose him because he's older than you. And what is this? Is this concern making you doubt whether or not you should still be with him? Is this your problem?
Yes, Miss Kat.
So you're afraid that you're going to lose him because he's older than you and you're not sure if you should be with him anymore because you want to avoid feeling that pain of losing him.
Yes, exactly, ma'am.
Okay. Do you love him?
I do love him. Mm-hmm. And I never felt this way before.
Okay.
Because I was like a closet gay.
Yeah.
Before I met him. I just had sex with some other guys.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just, I didn't do anything when I had sex with some other guys. They just do me.
Okay, gotcha. You were a bottom. Uh-huh. Yep. They just do me. That's so weird when guys say that.
I know.
I've never heard a guy say they just do me. Okay, yeah, so they'll just do you. Uh-huh.
I just lay there and the gay just do their thing to me.
Okay. Rams it in your butt.
We
get that visual very nicely. Thank you so much. And then?
And then when I met him, this love, it's just clicked. That,
he actually loops you up and slides it in slowly rather than just taking it. Do you play sexy music in the background?
Yeah.
Awesome.
That's fabulous.
Good job.
I also have a problem because of our relationship right now.
Okay, what's your problem with your relationship right now?
I wasn't able to know my father.
Okay.
And he also wasn't able to meet his daughter. He has his daughter.
Okay.
So basically, we have this like father and son thing right now. That parang nilalabas niya lahat sa akin yung pagkatatay niya and...
Whoa.
Freaking hilarious.
Okay.
You get it?
Okay, so he's kind of treating you like you're his child?
Yeah.
They just have fantasies about like,
I treat him like
you know what I mean?
Right
like,
now.
I totally get it, honestly. I do.
Wait, explain this to me. Fantasies about what are you talking about?
Not necessarily fantasies. It's just the fact that, you know, like he wasn't able to see his child and he didn't know his father. It's like they're kind of playing along to the whole neediness thing, but they kind of apply it to their sex life, mm-hmm, and they kind of make it like dirty and stuff like that. I totally get it.
Why? Do you actually have a father and son role thing when you have sex?
Honestly.
Not actually.
No?
In a relationship. No.
Okay. Just in your relationship. So like, so he's like telling you off and he's telling you what to do and he's getting involved in your life and he's like, dapat hindi ganyan yan and all this stuff.
Yeah.
Ah, okay. But so
para naging, he's older and is he the more doting one? Like you kind of feel like he's taking care of you.
No. Like what that. He's saying is that
the sexual thing.
No, it's not sexual. He's saying that his problem is that this guy is treating him like he's his son, not his boyfriend. So he's like making him pinapagalitan niya, like telling him what to do and all this stuff. And now he's starting to feel like he's his dad rather than his boyfriend.
Iyon yung problema. Okay. Parang gusto pang ituloy, pero parang ang gulo na.
Sa tingin mo ba, baka naman yan naman ang ugali niya? Maybe he's really like that. Maybe he is. Yeah, maybe he's just kind of. Kasi ako minsan, I have like a mommy trait to me where I'll tell people stuff. I'll be like, hoy, don't do that. And it's just because I'm just kind of like that. You know what I mean? You think maybe that he's just a little bit like that to everyone or his boyfriends? Or you think that maybe it's just you and it's because you're younger? And
yes, I totally get that. Because I was thinking also that maybe you feel that way because he's older. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's like if, for example, you were, I mean, just out of the box. For example, you were dating somebody who was the same age, who treated you the same way. He was getting mad at you, pinapagalitan ka, sinasabihan ka kung how to do things and stuff. Parang I don't think you would feel the same way, diba? Kasi same age kayo. Parang magiging mas, you guys are peers, so you would see it in a different way. But maybe you just feel that way because he's older.
Yeah, actually, right? That's true. Yeah. I mean, if a 22-year-old, the same age as you, was having the same thing and he was telling you the same things as this older guy is, would you feel the same way, you think?
No.
So you think that maybe it is because he's older? I mean, maybe you want to be with someone younger. Maybe that is your problem. I mean, if this is bothering you already and you're saying that you're afraid to lose him, parang natatakot ka na nga. And you know what? For me, though, the one thing is if you love someone, and I know that, you know, death and losing someone can be a very scary thing, especially if they're getting older. But you really have to consider, if you love the person, okay, then if you want to stay with them, stay with them. Do that. And if something happens, you know, that's what relationships are about. That's what life is about. Things happen and you deal with them and you move on. And, you know, I'm not to sound harsh about it, but, you know, you don't give up a really wonderful thing just because you're afraid that they're going to die. I mean, tomorrow, anybody could get hit by a bus, you know? So it's not a question. You can't live in fear of things that you don't know, you have no control of.
But enjoy the now. Okay?
Yeah, just enjoy what you have now. But at the same time, if you are feeling like you want to be with somebody younger and you want to like explore and you want to do stuff, you're still 23 years old, so you're really young, you know? And you have still a lot of things to experience in your life. So if you want to do that, then maybe it's time that you and he have a conversation about you being with you may be taking a break and or ending it now, and for you to find yourself. Because if you've been with him for 2 years, you've been with him since you were 20 years old, no?
Yeah.
And as a man, gay or straight, like at 20 years old, you're still kind of at your stages. No, not kind of. You really are at the stages where you're still exploring. You still want to try different things. You still want to experience life and find yourself and discover yourself. I mean, after the teenage years of all your hormones confusing you for ages, this is like the first couple of years of settling down, becoming an adult, you know, and you're just starting.
Knowing what you really want.
Diba? You're just starting. So if you don't want to be tied down and you want to have some fun, and I would completely understand that as well. So it's really up to you what you want to do.
Yeah, but the thing is, I want to be with him, like, for life.
Okay.
I'm like, nire-ready ko yung sarili ko na wala na siyang erectile dysfunction.
Uh-huh.
I really love him na talagang I want him beside me, like, 30 years more, 40 years more, parang ganun.
Then make the most out of what you have now. Don't be so scared. Just keep living. Diba?
Yeah.
Because at the end of the day, alam mo yun din yung sakit ng mga tao eh. Kasi a lot of us take advantage of what we have, that we only realize it when it's gone. It's actually good that you're thinking about these things, but at the same time, I think you should take more time into enjoying what you have now. Diba? Make the most out of it.
Yeah.
Right?
Absolutely. If you really want to stay with him, I mean, for me, you're young, so if you want to go out and live your life, you still have a long, long time ahead of you. And you never know. I mean, if you don't go out and experience all these other things in your life, you might change your mind later on, you know? But at the same time, if you do feel like you love him. And for me, because I've spoken to gay people before and they've told me that when they find a life partner, you know, it's rare for them to find someone who they feel like they can really spend their lives with. Yeah. You know what I mean? So I am not so quick to say to gay couples, you know, to split up and everything, unless it's abusive, or of course, then it's not a good idea. But if it's something like this where you really do love the guy and your fear is based on something that you have no control over, if you really love him and you think that it's really going to work out with you guys, then, you know, live in the moment, have fun, see how it goes. I mean, if at some point you feel like you can't do it anymore, you want to do something else, then you can always change your mind. You know, it's not like you're leading them on or anything. And maybe talk to him about his behavior also and the way that he talks to you. If it's really bothering you that he treats you like a kid and all this, and talk to him a little bit and be like, I'm not your son, you know, I'm your boyfriend and I need you to see me that way. And if you don't, it's going to cause an awkwardness between us because you don't want the age gap to define you. You don't want to feel your age when you're with the person that you're with. But you don't want to feel like, oh, you're older than me. Oh, I'm younger than you. You always want to feel like you're just equal. And so... yeah, I feel like you should talk to him about that as well if you're bothered by it.
Okay, so I'll just stay, ma'am.
So what?
So yeah. I stay with him?
Well, it's completely up to you, John. I mean, if you want to stay with him, stay with him. If you want to go somewhere else and live your life, then do that. It's your choice. We can't make that decision for you. We can only give you advice on both sides.
Okay, ma'am.
All right?
Thank you for it.
Okay, yeah. Thanks a lot, John. Alrighty, bye. Good luck to you. I hope it works out. And if you do end up spending your life with him, then have a really good one with him.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Alrighty, that's cute though, right? Like, yeah, they're like little turtle doves. They mate for life or whatever. Yeah. That's cute. Aww. Anyway, we gotta go into a commercial break right now. We're taking more of your calls and fixing more of your problems when we get back right here on Good Times with Mo podcast.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
Ako po ay isang barbero. Ngunit ang ikukwento ko po sa inyo ay hindi kwentong barbero. Dati po kasi ay nagtatrabaho ko sa isang barberya sa bayan. Sa kasamaang palad po ay nasunog yun. Kaya nawalan ako ng trabaho. Kaya naisipan ko po na magdikit ng flyers ng globe number ko for home service. Hindi ko po akalain na magkakaroon ako ng maraming customers. Dahil po sa dumami ang customers ko na taga iba't ibang lugar, eh nakaipon po ako ng sapat para makapagpatayo na rin po ako ng sarili kong barberya. Napagpatapos ko na rin ang aking mga anak sa pag-aaral. Kumanda na rin po ang aming buhay sa ngayon. Salamat sa Globe.
Hey, Mo Twister here. All right, podcasters, listen up because this is really, really important. Major Homes brings you unique and creative developments, giving you a real chance at a sure, affordable, and hassle-free investment. Invest in your future today. Call 0917-517-4287. Major Homes is here.
What you've been missing on The Factory.
Were you the one who posted, James, regarding the guidelines when it comes to checkpoints?
Yes, I
That's
was.
That's fantastic.
Yes, I just made it up, but, you know, I thought...
You made it up?
I mean, this time of year, right? Elections. You know, you never let the truth get in the way of a good story, okay? Children, do not follow this at home. I'm just kidding. Just so you know your rights, if you do get stopped by a checkpoint...
You're not allowed
We're able to verify all of these, James.
You're not allowed to run over them. That didn't make it here. So technically... Now, number two, upon approach, slow down. I guess that counts as not running them over. Dim headlights and slow turn down. On cabin lights. Okay.
Cabin lights. Mm-hmm.
Lock all doors of vehicles during inspection.
Since lock?
Lock.
They might get pissed off because you're locking
But
covers.
That's the thing. Okay. This is where they get you. And this is actually, I know we're making fun of it a little bit, but this is a serious issue. We've seen some people genuinely harassed. Drugs are planted.
And
other things, you know. A Justin Bieber CD is planted, which is even worse.
Oh, yes, no.
I've heard of that, you know. And there's no defense for that. There's really no defense. Yeah, it's like, but Your Honor, we found this. Throw the book at him. The CD as well.
Then after that, you have to submit your cell phone and everything. Yeah. And next thing you know, you have a Justin Bieber ringtone.
Catch James Deacon and the Boys on Counterflow Wednesdays, 7:30 to 8:30, only here on The Factory.
Take a little sunshine.
Hey, podcasters, Mo here. You ever watch the podcast, right? And you're sitting there and you're looking at our female celebrity guest and you're looking at her skin and you're like, wow, I'd love to have that complexion. Well, your answer is this. Glutamax, the official skin whitening partner of Miss Earth International. Available in capsules, soaps, lotion, deodorant, and face cream. Bikutis Mayaman with Glutamax. It's available in leading drugstores and supermarkets nationwide. Podcasters, listen up. Big announcement. The Chevrolet Sonic is a dependable 5-seater subcompact vehicle, and it delivers sufficient power, fuel efficiency, refined ride and handling, and a remarkable entertainment system. The Sonic is the perfect Chevrolet vehicle for those who are looking to make their daily city commute or weekend getaway drives more fun and exciting. It comes in two great body styles, the 5-door hatchback and a 4-door sedan. Equipped with a new 1.4-liter Ecotec engine with double continuous variable cam phase, that's CVC, the Chevy Sonic provides efficient power and quality driving performance. Now, to further highlight the youthful, sporty, and fun characteristics of the Sonic, Chevrolet has equipped the compact sedan with high-tech convenient features such as Bluetooth connectivity and audio streaming capabilities that are commonly found only on high-trim compact sedans. The Chevrolet Sonic is available at all Chevrolet dealers. It comes with a Chevrolet 5-year warranty, 3-year free roadside assistance, and the services of a 24/7 Chevy hotline.
Hi, everybody. I'm Bianca Valeria.
I'm Julia
Sintanera.
I'm Trisha
Sintanera. And we are the girls of 20. Yay! Okay, so you have to be wondering, what on earth is 20?
Exactly. So find out every Sunday night, 8-9. Hang out with us. Mm-hmm. We're going to be talking about everything under the sun.
Girls, boys.
Boobs. Boobs.
Okay, boobs.
Boobs. You say boobs. Eventually, the phone number will come.
But since in the meantime, we can't figure out the whole podcast thing, out, but we're trying to figure out voice, figure
out. We can't get ourselves out, so we know what's going on.
Exactly. Okay, anyway, our first podcast is this Sunday at 8.
Yeah.
Please join us because we're all here.
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
All right, we're back here in Good Times with Mo. You're hanging out with me, Kat Alano, and Max Eigenmann. Now, are you ready to get your game on? A Chevrolet Philippines brings to you the Chevrolet Sonic, a sporty and stylish subcompact car that has a 1.4-liter Ecotec engine with 6-speed automatic transmission that provides dependable speed, power, and fuel efficiency. The Chevrolet Sonic is also equipped with high-tech features such as steering wheel-mounted audio controls with USB, AUX. You say AUX or AUX? AUX and Bluetooth full audio streaming connectivity. The Sonic is available in hatchback and sedan variants. Dare to take on life's challenges head on and complement your A-game with the all-new Chevrolet Sonic. Visit your nearest Chevrolet dealership or log on to the www.chevroletsonic.com.ph to check out the all-new 2013 Chevrolet Sonic. Game on! There you go. And guys, we are hanging out with Max Eigenmann tonight, who came in here and is giving some awesome advice to people. If you want to call us up as well, go ahead. Our numbers are 478-7954 and 0927-360-0485. Skype, the Good Times Podcast. And we have another caller. We have Hannah. Hannah, 28 years old in Paranaque. Hannah, are you there? Hello? No? No? Oh, okay, we'll call her back. All right, well, while we're still here, what would you like to talk about?
You.
Oh, she's there?
Oh, she's there. Hi, Hannah. Are you here?
We're totally going to have a conversation over Hannah. Hannah, are you there?
Hello?
Hi, Hannah.
I know, like you're having morning. Sex. Hey, Hannah, what's up?
Hi.
Hi. Hi, Hannah, what's going on?
Yes, I do have a problem.
What's your problem?
I'm living with my boyfriend.
Okay.
For quite some time now.
Mm-hmm.
Then last week, his father, however, we're not, you know, he seldom sleeps with me because he's very busy with work.
Whoa. Okay. He
yeah,
doesn't sleep with you.
Father, because... Yeah. Yeah. And then last week, his very hot father came back from U.S., I mean, for a visit for a three-month visit here. Now, what happened is I had sex with the father twice already.
Already means that you're planning on doing it again.
How old are you, sweetie? Okay, wait, 28, am I right?
Yes, I'm 20.
And boyfriend is how old?
28.
Okay, so that would make father...
The father is like around 45.
Whoa, okay, so he's a young dad, huh?
Yes.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Yeah, he got the girl pregnant when he was, really? What is that, 28, 45? My math is absolutely terrible, okay? I'm not even going to embarrass myself. You had him when he was 16, is that what you said?
I'm sorry?
What did you say? He had him when he was how old?
I think he's 45 to 50.
Oh, 45 to 50?
So you
don't even know
sure
how old he is
exactly?
I'm not really sure because I never asked my boyfriend about him.
Before we answer your question, can you just say that you are wild, girl?
I know, you crazy, girl. Bringing it up all up in there, daddy. You know what I'm saying? That literally, call me daddy. Whoa, it's kind of weird, bro.
Oh, my God.
But he's pretty good.
What, sorry?
He's pretty good with regards to his, you know, bed skills.
Well, of course he is, honey. He is a lot older than you.
He's much older than me, so I get it. But, like, I would never, I mean, I'm sorry, but I don't understand you. I mean, I get that you are sleeping with somebody older, and I totally get that you're sleeping with him because he's got great bed skills and why you've done it more than once.
Yes, and you're planning on doing it again because you said already.
No. What the hell?
No. My question is, not really a question. I'm asking if you can give me advice on how to make it stop.
How to make it stop? Don't sleep with him.
Period. Don't sleep with him. Don't open your legs.
Don't
even see him.
Don't make bukaka. That's
exactly
the easy answer.
Don't bend over. Don't make bukaka. Don't act like you're, oh, daddy. You know what I mean? daddy. No, sweetie. Hannah, I get it. My boyfriend's much older than me. I understand. Oh, but man, I was not awesome. Dating his son. So if you want to stop, all you gotta do is stop.
Yeah,
seriously. Like,
no, wait. But you know
gone.
What? This isn't as simple as all that, okay?
It's true.
Number one, I want
to
know why it is.
Go ahead.
I know, right? Why is it that your boyfriend does not sleep with you?
Yes. Maybe he's gay. No, but go on.
Actually,
sorry.
He's a military pilot. So right now he's into flying school, graduating for flying school. So medyo
busy.
Hindi niya ako nag-free time and things like that.
Have you guys had sex?
No, my question is, why is it that you have time to spend with a dad? I mean, like, why are you spending a lot of time with a dad? If he came to visit from the States for a couple of months, why is it na kung wala yung anak niya, which is your boyfriend, why is it that you guys are hanging out? How did this come about, even?
Because he's staying in the same house.
I'm curious
about this.
They live together.
Oh.
So the dad is staying with them. So wait, so your boyfriend doesn't sleep with you ever? Has he ever had sex with you? Have you ever had sex with him?
No. Well, we do that. Pero yun nga lang, very seldom siya lately. So parang kahit kalabitin ko siya, wala, walang mangyayari.
So, so you're saying na parang you're sleeping with the, I mean, that this whole thing with the dad came about kasi, sorry for the word, actually I'm not sorry for the word, kasi tigang ka? Ganun ba yun?
Parang
so
ganun.
Like, you're kind of like hungry for sexual attention, that's why you ended up sleeping with a dad because he was the one who was around?
Yeah, and ano eh, flirtatious din yung father eh. So, ano yun?
Tang ina, sorry.
Okay. Wait, how old? Wait. I lost my question. I'm so confused right now. Wait, how long has it been? Go ahead. How long has it been since you slept with your boyfriend?
Siguro a month na.
Have you slept with your boyfriend after you slept with the dad? In between the times that you were sleeping with the dad, did you actually sleep with the son, your boyfriend?
Not yet.
Okay. So,
medyo fucked up din tong.
Yeah, this is a funny story.
Yes.
Do you okay, there is something deeper going on here obviously, but
sure.
Number one is your boyfriend sleeping with somebody else?
Since he's from the military, so may pagkababaero siya. Aminado naman siya na he's flirting with other women. Pero,
whoa!
He tells me na, whoa! It's nothing serious.
He says what?
He tells me it's nothing serious.
It's nothing serious, honey. How long have you been with this guy again?
That's around a year and a half now.
Oh, sweetheart, are you okay with this open stuff?
I'm actually not okay with that. Ganun yung nangyayari kahit ayoko. Parang hindi ko naman siya mapakawalan. Ayaw niya rin naman napakawalan ko siya.
Why ayaw mo pakawalan siya? Why?
I think he still needs me.
Needs you?
As a person to
you know what, sweetie?
Oh,
okay. Sorry, I really have something to say about this. But
go ahead.
So you like the fact that you're being needed by this guy?
I'm sorry.
You like being needed? Is that why you're still with him?
Yes, I think so.
Well, but in terms of the sexual thing, are you actually sexually attracted to him still?
Yes.
But the reason why I'd like to know the reason why. I mean, even if you say na dahil because hindi kanya binibigyan ng sexual attention, that's why you ended up sleeping with his father. Do you actually enjoy the whole thing with the dad and stuff like that?
He's good, pero minsan naiimagine ko na he's the fun.
Okay, no, Hannah. Look, okay. I'm going to say something that Mo says all the time. You need to get yourself some professional help. Okay, number one, there's a big, deep issue here that is rooted in there, which makes you believe that you have to hang on to a guy
that
is sleeping with other women, and you are supposed to behave yourself. I'm guessing that if he knew that you were sleeping with anybody else, let's ignore the fact for a second that it is his father, that he would totally freak out and say that he's going to leave you, right?
Yeah.
So there's a double standard in your relationship.
Okay naman kami, pero lately,
no,
madalas kami.
That
you're
wasn't
not okay.
What I said. I didn't ask you if you're okay. I said there is a double standard in your relationship. Mm-hmm. Tama?
Tama.
You know what double standard means, right?
Yes.
Means that he has rules that he abides by, but if you use those rules, it's
against
not the
him,
same thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, and number one, you know, how can you be okay with your man sleeping with other women?
Hindi naman siya nag-admit na ganon, pero I'm not okay with it.
Pero sabi mo sa akin na sa amin na babaero nga siya and that he sleeps with other women. So,
and
he does sleep with other women.
And that he just says that it's not serious.
Yeah.
Parang wala na lang. Kesa pag-awayan pa namin sa minsan pinalalagpas ko na lang siya.
So, imbis na pag-awayan nyo to avoid the drama, you'd rather not talk about the fact that your man is sleeping with other women and you'd rather stay with him because of what need you have. You don't even really want to be stay with him. I mean, unless you're doing this sleeping with his dad thing out of revenge. Is this revenge for you to sleep with his dad? Sleep with the one person that would really piss him off? Because it really would piss him off that his dad was stabbing his girlfriend, okay? It's going to piss
him off. Or his girlfriend was stabbing his dad. I mean, it's like a freaking lose-lose situation both sides.
Either way, it's fucked up. Either way. Anyway, you know, so why, if you love this guy, why did you sleep with dad?
Actually, the dad is flirting.
I don't care.
That's not the point. It
guys
takes two
flirt
to fucking
with me
fuck
all the time. If
it takes
I step
two
with,
to fucking fuck, come
right?
on.
Yeah, it takes two to tango.
The dad just has to flirt and you got to open your legs and you opened your legs. Why?
Yeah, if
you
flirted
this
with
guy,
every guy that hit on me, I would be the biggest whore in town, seriously. Like that. It's just, you don't sleep with everybody that flirts with you. It's not an excuse. You don't use it as a reason.
Or being tigang is not an excuse either. There are vibrators being sold.
I honestly, Hannah, I think that there is a different reason behind you having slept with his dad. I think maybe that you have a couple of daddy issues thrown in there.
Yes,
do you have
exactly.
some family
maybe
problems?
You're actually even more attracted to the dad. And maybe you're, like you said earlier, right, Hannah, that when you are sleeping with his father, you're imagining that it's him. Maybe you're maybe you're doing that because you're trying to cover up the fact that you're actually attracted to older men.
Or
and there's nothing
maybe
wrong with
subconsciously
that.
She's really trying to get back at her boyfriend. I mean, she's thinking that it's her boyfriend.
She knows that it's the person who would piss him off the most.
Which means, you know what? You don't really want to sleep with the dad. You just did it because he's sleeping with other women. You're trying to make yourself feel better about it. You know what? Number one, stop banging the dad. If you want to stop banging him, all you got to do is not open your legs anymore and stop taking down your panty and letting him do all that
and
stuff.
And if your boyfriend is not around and if he's flirting with you, just freaking go away and shut down. It just shouldn't be that hard to freaking shut down a man, right?
Yeah.
Unless you're so afraid because, oh my God, I'm disrespecting my boyfriend's father. I can't say no. I got to open my legs. But it's not that hard. Come on.
No, but you know what? At the end of the day, you need to leave this guy. Okay, Hannah? You need to go away.
He's giving you more issues than I think you might already have.
Yeah. And to be fair with you, number one, you should respect yourself more than to have a guy who's cheating on you. Okay? This is a terrible, terrible thing for you to believe that you deserve a guy who's sleeping with other women, but he's telling you it's okay because I love you, baby. My other girls are just whores. That is not okay. This man, number one, has no respect for women and he has no respect for you. So it's really a bad idea for you to stay with him. As much as it hurts, I know breakups suck, but at the end of the day, don't you want to be with somebody who's not going to fuck around on you for the rest of your life? Did we lose Hannah? Okay, well, Hannah, you know, you need to break up with this guy. If you feel like you deserve to be with somebody who's going to fuck around on you for the rest of your life, because this is what's going to happen, because you've already made it normal. You've already let it slide, so he's always going to do this to you because he knows
you're
always taking
it back. Normal,
it's not normal. Hannah, are you there?
Yeah.
It is not normal for your boyfriend to cheat on you with other women. It is not normal for you to have a relationship like that. It's not normal for you to sleep with your boyfriend's father. And if you stay with your boyfriend now and you stop having sex with the dad, you can't go back to the son. I'm sorry.
Yes, and you're going to die in guilt, first of all.
You are going to have this like on your conscience, and you're never going to be able to tell the son, okay? I don't care what happens, but that is between him and his daddy. It is not between you and him. I don't know. Okay, do you agree with me?
I totally agree. I think that the way for you to stop sleeping... for you to stop sleeping with a dad and for you to stop stressing about your boyfriend not sleeping, just leave them both. Seriously, it's kind of... fucked up family.
This is a bad situation, honey. You need to move out. You need to go live your life. You need to go buy yourself a new dress, buy some new makeup, get your hair done, get your nails done, go out, have a party with your girlfriends, and have some single you time and find out what the hell you really want from a man, because you don't need a man who wants to fuck other girls. You know, I always say that if a man doesn't want to be with you solidly, then don't
then
be with
fuck
him.
Seriously. I love a man who wants me for all I am.
Exactly.
Don't you? I mean, isn't it fucked up for you to actually find this attention from somebody else, more likely the father of your son?
Instead of the father of your boyfriend?
Sorry.
Who is supposed to be the man
that
who
is giving you the attention,
you and giving
right?
you your attention, right? Why do you have to look for it somewhere else if you're already supposed to be getting it from this guy? Diba?
So wag na.
Yeah.
Diba? At the end of the day, just leave both.
Okay.
All right.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Good job.
I'm out of his house right now. I went home kasi nga I'm avoiding na the father kasi baka maulit-ulit.
Hindi naman kailangan maulit kapag sinabi mong hindi na mauulit eh.
Yeah.
Diba?
Mm-hmm.
So I'm the dad. I'm gonna come up to you. Hey, Hannah, wanna have sex right now? What do you say?
What do you say?
I'm sorry, what?
No. I'm the dad, I come up to you and I'm like, hey, Hannah, you wanna go get freaky in the next room right now? What do you say?
I say no.
Good and then?
Job. And then leave.
Good job.
Good job. Para Jan. Awesome job, yeah, Hannah. Thank you so much. All right, well, good luck to you, okay? Move out. You. Stop sleeping with the dad.
And leave the boy.
Leave the son.
Leave
the son alone.
Stay home.
They sound like a slutty family. They sound like they're slutty in general. So just get out of there, okay?
Okay, thank you.
All right, you take care of yourself. Good luck. Good luck. I'll speak to you soon. Bye-bye. All right, you guys, we got to go into another little break right there, but we'll be right back taking more of your calls and fixing Malvio shit right here. We'll be right back.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
We're always on the move. It's really important for us to get better and stronger for every competition that we get into. For all the different lifestyles that we have, some of us are graphic artists, filmmakers. We still find ways to get together. We put a lot of effort in practicing and rehearsing. Minsan may mga biglaang shows or auditions, so it's really important for us to get connected. I use my Globe group messaging to get a hold of everybody else. Malayo na rin ang narating namin, marami na rin kaming napuntahan. So it's really important to get connected.
What you've been missing on the factory.
Now we're gonna show you guys the new beta that just came out yesterday. Is God of War Ascension, the private beta
for PlayStation Plus.
PlayStation Plus.
Let's watch it, right? It's not. It's Enrico playing already.
Yes.
Yep.
There you go. And perfect timing.
But before that, I was kicking ass.
So go with the theme of the show, How Not to Play.
It's Robot Rice and Friends with Alfonso Martinez, Mickey Han, and Nigel Zalameo. Fridays, 6 to 7 p.m., only here on The Factory.
Hey, podcasters, Mo here. You ever watch the podcast, right? And you're sitting there and you're looking at our female celebrity guest and you're looking at her skin and you're like, wow, I'd love to have that complexion. Well, your answer is this. Glutamax, the official skin whitening partner of Miss Earth International. Available in capsules, soaps, lotion, deodorant, and face cream. Bikutis Mayaman with Glutamax. It's available in leading drugstores and supermarkets nationwide.
Then the maid got jaundice. Jaundice is different from jaundice. Jaundice is buntis, like that. But she does not... Tirso! Anyway, jaundice does not know. This is professional show. I will put the merienda here. So, jaundice. And I am now happy to present to you Carl Lutario. Look at this, tumi tayo. Gusto mo yung snacks? Ano ba to? Ganyan ba yan? Tapos?
Ang puti.
Tapos, dito ba pwede ba dyan?
Pwede. Consider. Yan, para sa show mo ha, o.
Rico, amayaya ba? Pwede ba itong ano? Zora, pang ano ba to? Oil absorbing? Pwede pa itong pa-nose line?
Tita oh. Kay, may caution.
Caution! Ah! Basta ng glamour te!
Oh. When used for the first 2 weeks, more pimples will appear. Burahin na, burahin na
siya. Oh my God! Damn!
Sorry, ma'am.
Pabasok yung gamot!
Ito talaga?
Hindi, bago yan. Don't worry.
Buti ako sa mata lang. Hindi naman nagkatap yun. But dapat pala, caution muna yung pinasin natin.
Join your host, Carrots Nazareno, on Live, Love, Lols every Thursday, 7:30 to 8:30, only here on The Factory.
Hey, Mo Twister here. All right, podcasters, listen up, because this is really, really important. Major Homes brings you unique and creative developments, giving you a real chance at a sure, affordable, and hassle-free investment. Invest in your future today. Call 0917-517-4287. Major Homes is here.
Take a little sunshine.
I'm Trisha Santanera, and we are the girls of 28! Okay, so you have to be wondering, what on earth is 28?
Exactly, so find out every Sunday night, 8-9, hang out with us! Mm-hmm. We're going to be talking about everything under the sun.
Girls, boys,
boobs, boobs.
Okay, books, fine. Books, you say boobs.
Of course, yeah.
Sure. You can call us, we can do a phone.
We want to talk to you guys too.
Yeah. Eventually the phone number will come.
But since in the meantime we can't figure out the whole podcasting figure spot, but we're trying to figure out voice, figure
we can make it ourselves out, so we know what's going on.
Exactly.
Okay.
Anyway, our first podcast is this Sunday at 8.
Yeah.
Please join us because we're all here.
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
All right, guys, what's happening? Thank you for staying with us. And thank you to everybody who's been calling. Please keep calling us, 478-7954. You're still here on the Good Times with Mo podcast with me, Kat Alano. And, of course, the beautiful Max Eigenmann, who I'm so glad came out today because I haven't seen her in forever. Well, apart from the other day for like 5 seconds. But,
which isn't counted.
Yeah, which doesn't count because it hasn't been solid. But I'm so glad she's here with me to help me fix your shit. Because that's what we like to do. We're like pake la mera like that, and we like to get in there and niggle all the details.
Etchecera.
Yes. Etchecera. There you go. Etchecera. All right, so we got a couple of more callers who are on the lines right now. If the lines are full, guys, please keep calling us. We will try and get to your calls as soon as we can, all right? So here we go. We got another call. This one is from Singapore. Jason, 28 years old. Jason, are you there?
Yeah, hi.
Hi, Jason. How are you? Wow, you have a really clear line. I like that. All the way from Singapore. How are you?
Yeah, I'm fine. Kind of bored here.
Jason, please meet my friend Max. This is Max.
Hi, Jason.
Yeah, hi.
So how can we help you this evening?
I have a question. This is a kind of corny question, I guess.
Okay, that's okay. We can do corny.
Hola.
Okay, is it really worth it to be in love with someone you really never met?
Oh, that's not a corny question. That's really interesting. Wait, okay. Is it worth it to be in love with someone that you've never met?
Yeah.
Why? Who are you in love with?
Actually, I met a girl online.
You met a girl online. Okay.
Everything even more interesting.
Yes. Okay. So tell us all about it, Jason. Tell us how you met her, you know, how long you've been talking to her on all this stuff.
I met her through Twitter.
Okay, so okay. She tweeted you something sexy and you were like, hey.
Stop, y'all.
No, it's kind of, I just followed her in a random way.
Okay.
Then, DM.
Uh-huh.
DM her, then she replied, and we started talking.
Okay.
That's it. And, I just found her interesting, then I'm surprised that every day we were talking. That's it. Then both of us realized that we're kind of in love, but it is not that right.
It's not that right?
Yeah, because I have a girlfriend.
Oh, so that's what makes it wrong. But
the plot thickens. Ooh, all right, this is a juicy call. I don't know why you're telling us it's corny, Jason. This is not a corny call. Okay, Jason, why are you chatting with random chicks online if you have a girlfriend? Are things going sour with your girl?
Maybe this is like what we call the pros and cons of being away. That's it.
being OA. So how long have you been with your girlfriend?
Being away.
Oh,
so you're not with her. She's back home?
Yeah. Your girlfriend, doesn't matter.
Your girlfriend
doesn't matter. He's never met the girl on Twitter either. So either way, he's kind of screwed here. You like to complicate matters.
You're online thingy with your girlfriend, but you're not. You're having it with somebody else. So go on.
Absolutely. Okay. So how long have you been with a girlfriend that isn't with you?
Well, she's my best friend. That's it. We've been like together forever.
How long is forever? You're 28. So how long is forever? I mean, I'm not dead yet, so forever hasn't lasted for me.
Since high school.
So, what, like 10 years?
Yeah.
Wow.
More than 10 years.
So, you started dating when you were how old? Like 16, 17?
I don't really remember.
You don't even remember?
I don't that age. 18, 17.
Around that age, okay. Well, it's kind of bad that you don't remember when your anniversary is and stuff, do you?
What? Sorry?
Do you remember when your anniversary is?
Of course, I know.
Okay, but you don't know how long you've been together?
Huh?
But you don't know how many years you've been together.
Oh, I mean, it's a different thing when you're friends. Then you're
so you've been friends for a long time, but you've been dating for you don't know how long.
No, Is that what you're saying? 2 years.
So you've only been dating for 2 years, but you've been friends for like 10 years.
Yeah.
Okay, I get it. I thought you've been dating since you were in high school. So you really know this girl really well, and you really love her, and you're together now. Why did you guys get together? Did you realize that you're both in love with each other? Or was it like a, you know, we're best friends, and best friends should marry each other, so let's be together kind of thing?
Well, maybe because in my insight was the only... I'm not really sure, but what I meant is the best person that you would be in love with is maybe your friend or your best friend, because he or she knows particularly everything about you.
You know what your problem is? You're playing it safe, Jason. You know what? This happens to people all the time.
People are not really in love.
Yeah, people always have this misconception because of like things in movies where they're like, marry your best friend. They don't mean take your best friend now and marry them. I mean, if it happens that way, it's because you realize you're madly in love with your best friend. It's not because, oh, you're my best friend. You know what? They say we should marry each other. Let's get married. I mean, I have a best friend who loves me too, but I'm not about to get with him because that would be a really dumb idea because I don't love him like that. I want him to be with someone who loves him completely 100%, and the things that I can't give him, she will give him, and he will be the happiest person alive. That is what I want from my best friend. Now, you know, if you are dating her because of those reasons, because she is your best friend and you believe that being with your best friend is the best thing to be with because forever is a long time and whatever, I mean, what's really supposed to happen in a relationship, and correct me if you think I'm wrong, okay, is that you are supposed to develop a relationship with somebody so well and so intently and so be so well gelled together that you are each other's best friend, not the other way around. I mean, am I wrong? I know in some cases...
No, I agree.
I know in some cases it does happen where you do fall in love with your best friend, and by all means,
that's
cool.
But you can't say that you're my best friend, so I'm in love with you now.
Yeah.
You know, you can't force that reason. It's two different things.
Yeah, absolutely. It's two different things. You can't be like, you're my best friend, so let's get together. It's like, oh my gosh, you know what? I realize that there's nobody else in the world like you, and I want to be madly in love with you for the
and
rest of my life.
And I'm lucky because you're my best friend as well.
Right, exactly. It's a bonus that you're my best friend.
It's a bonus.
You know, but if you're just doing it to be safe, I mean, you kind of proved it to yourself by the fact that you've met somebody that you think is more interesting, and you haven't even met her yet. Doesn't that tell you something, that you're already looking at other people or talking to other people that you don't even know, which makes your life really complicated by the way? Either you don't like having sex, or you're just really into the long distance thing, because I don't know why you would try and do it again with somebody else that is very far away. Where does this other girl on Twitter live, by the way? Is she in the States?
No, she's there too.
She's where?
She's there, Philippines.
Ah, she's in the Philippines. So are they both here?
Yes.
Oh, delikado pa yan, di ba?
Baka magkaibigan pala yan, di mo alam.
If they find out about each other, yun pala, nagbump into each other, nagbugbugan sa bar. Yes, that's fine.
No. I don't think so.
Yeah, you don't think so. So what is it about this new girl that you really like so much?
Well, I don't know. I can even explain. I'm not really sure. Maybe because I'm lonely here, or maybe it's the real thing. Actually, if a lot of mean, some of my close friends asked me about this and I can't even answer them straight.
Okay. Now, like, my next question,
like,
is...
I'm really lost and I don't really know what I want.
My next question is, are you sure that this person that you're talking to on Twitter really exists?
She is.
Like, are you sure she's a real person? Like, have you Skyped with her? Have you seen her talk to you face-to-face? Or has it just been, like, DMs and, like, phone calls? Does she look the way you think she looks? Have you seen her live?
She really is. I saw her live through Skype.
Through Skype.
Oh, so you use Skype.
Okay, so you've Skyped with each other. Because sometimes, you know, people use avatars that are not themselves, sure, and they pretend they're other people. Okay, so you've met her. So you think you have feelings for her, which... Where does that leave you and your best friend?
I'm sorry, but...
Where does that leave you and your best friend? I mean, do you still love your best friend? Is it a love that is a best friend kind of love? Or is it a love that is, I want to be with you for the rest of my life, be my girlfriend kind of love?
Yes, of course, I love her so much.
Yes, but what kind of love is it? Is it a friend kind of love, or is it I want to be with you kind of love?
You guys ask questions. Great.
Yeah.
It's just great.
I know. You answer them.
I like you, Jason.
You answer them funny, but it's cool.
Actually... I don't know. Yes. You know,
okay. Well, you know what? You know what?
I thought about it for a long time, which means
I think it hurt your brain cells a little bit there when you thought about that one. That sounded like it hurt. Listen to me, Jason. What it really sounds like to me is that you have no idea what you want right now. Okay, so. Number one, I think you need to, I think you need to take a break. I think you need to do some soul searching. I think you need to not commit yourself to either one of these girls right now. And
technically,
decide.
It shouldn't be a hard thing to do because they're both not with him. You know what I mean? I mean, they're both long distance things, and you should try to assess yourself. And I don't think it's about who he really wants. I think he's just. I think that you might be playing with the fact that they're away. Maybe you just don't... Maybe right now all you need is time alone with yourself. And make the most of the fact that... Because they're both away. I mean, I would totally understand if the new girl that you met was actually with you now. Like, you met this girl and your best friend, the one you've been with for a long time, has been with you since before and she's the one who was away. But they're both away. So I actually don't understand that, honestly. I mean, that's me.
No, but at this time, also, you're kind of lucky because you don't have, like, the whole sex thing. You're not having sex with either of them. You're not getting any. you know, you're not having sex with either of them. You're not holding hands with them. They're not there every day with you. So you have a lot of time to reflect by yourself. You know, you don't have the pressure of them actually standing there being like, who do you pick? Do you want to be with me or them? So you're really in a lucky position right now because you can take time to yourself and think about both girls. You can think about whether or not... I mean, how long have you been talking to the girl on Twitter again?
It's almost half a year.
Half a year. So you know what? If you are thinking that you're in love with this girl, emotionally you're already cheating on your best friend. You know that, right?
Yeah.
So that's probably, for me, actually the worst kind of cheating.
Yes, it's the emotional kind.
Yeah, emotional kind of cheating is the worst kind of cheating. To know that your partner is no longer in love with you like they used to be and they're in love with someone else is actually more heartbreaking than having found out that they had sex with a whore, to be really honest with you.
I understand. I totally agree.
You know what I mean? It's actually more heartbreaking to find that out. So if you are already emotionally cheating on your girlfriend, as your best friend, okay, let's forget the fact that she's your girlfriend. As your best friend that you've known since you were 18 years old, do you really want her to be with a guy who's not as interested in her anymore? If you were just her friend and she was dating a guy who is like you and is doing what you are doing, what would you tell your best friend? Would you tell her that she should stay with you?
I hope not to answer that question.
There you go. You're really terrible at answering my questions, but I'm good at asking them. See, if you don't know what you would tell her, that means that I'm right. Right, Jason?
Yeah.
So I think the answer to your question here is that maybe you need to let your best friend go. I mean, at least in terms of the relationship. Yeah, and really be her friend. You know, think about this as her friend as well, because people always forget this when they're in a relationship with somebody. You know, they see a girlfriend, boyfriend, this title makes people forget that who they're with is a person, first and foremost, okay? And it's supposed to be your friend. So when anybody ever cheats or, you know, treats them badly and stuff, I'm like, if this was your friend, What would you tell them, right?
Exactly.
What advice would you give them about what you are doing to them and how you're treating them as a person? And you really can't do that. You have to be good to your girlfriend or boyfriend or not be with them at all. You're not being a good friend, first and foremost. You're being a terrible friend, right?
For sure.
And I think that to really be, if you want to call her your best friend,
You're not being a very good best friend right now.
Like, really, you're not being her best friend. You're being the worst friend possible to her right now. And I know you don't mean it. I know you haven't thought about it like that. And I know that what you're doing started off probably very innocently, although probably not that innocently. If you were actually looking to talk to somebody and you started DMing them, that sounds to me like you already had a motive. Why would you start talking to a girl that you thought was attractive behind your girlfriend's back? Does she know?
No.
No, she doesn't know. That's what I thought. So I think that you need to be fair on your girlfriend, and you need to tell her that you are not in the same place, that you think it's unfair to her if you keep her in this relationship. Also, if she's the same age as you, how old is your girlfriend? She's 28 as well?
Yeah.
If she's the same age as you, okay, honey, at 28 years old, women start to go through the phase of wanting to get serious. In about 2 or 3 years' time, this woman is going to have her biological clock ticking. She's going to want to have kids. She's going to want to have a settled down life and all of these things. And, you know, if you can't really give that to her, then let her find somebody who will.
Mm-hmm.
You can't have both.
Yeah.
That's unfair to both of you.
Yeah.
Even to you, it's a little bit unfair. Because then you be with somebody who you're not happy with.
Yeah, and you're being with her.
Which is the least anybody would want.
Right? Yeah, and you're being with her for the wrong reasons. You know, forget all this stuff that the world tells you is what you're supposed to do in love, okay? Why don't people want to just fall in love? Why is everything so complicated?
Come on, it's the best thing on earth.
Yeah, love is not this complicated. You want to do it, just do the right thing. End it with your girlfriend. And if
you
really
think... Give yourself a chance.
Yes.
But you know, I mean,
it might not even...
Hello? Yes? But I agree with you guys. If you have a relationship, you don't have to put any label on it. I agree with that.
What? That wasn't what we said at all. Did you misinterpret what we just said?
I think you did.
Maybe.
Yeah. See, I wasn't talking about not putting labels on your relationship. I was talking about that when people have a label on someone, like, say, if Max was my girlfriend, okay, just because she's here and she's not a boy. If Max was my girlfriend, which I'd be very lucky to have her.
Oh.
And I was, wait, what was my point? I totally lost myself in your eyes. Max looked at me and I lost myself in her eyes. What's my point again?
Okay, if somebody else was your boyfriend...
Yes.
And you met me on the internet, what would you think?
See, that's the thing. If I met her on the internet and she was an amazing person, okay? Like, if I want to be with her and I feel like I'm falling in love with her, and you've been talking to her for a while, right? It's been six months already. So if you really feel like you're falling in love with her, then, you know, you need to tell your girl that...
Give yourself... a chance to find out if you actually are in love with the other girl.
Yeah.
If that's what you think. Because the fact that you're doubting yourself if you're in love with her or not, the fact that you're already questioning this relationship with somebody else should give you all the reasons to leave your best friend.
Yeah.
And be the best friend that you are.
And don't just hold on to your best friend because you're afraid of being alone or you're afraid
or
you're making
afraid
a mistake.
Her.
Or
you
yeah,
will hurt her more in the long run.
Yeah. If you are lying to her now... you will hurt her harder in the long run
than if you end
it sooner. You know what I mean? And don't do that stuff. People do that all the time. We're like, oh, but what if I'm making a mistake? What if I'm being, you know, what if I don't really
the
like
this
girl?
The fact that you're asking what if?
Yeah.
It's already proof enough that you're making a mistake.
Yeah.
Because you're questioning it.
Yeah. And if you've been questioning it for 6 months, that means that, you know, you are probably not happy where you are anymore.
If you're questioning it for 6 months, that means you already have the answer, sweetie.
Yeah. You know what you need to do, Jason. And it is nothing to do with not being girlfriend and boyfriend and keeping your relationship going, okay? It is about just stopping it. Just stop. And then take some time to reflect. Take some time for yourself. Don't get with this other girl really fast and have another long-distance relationship. Be by yourself for a while and think about what you really want, what kind of a person you want, and what you want to be within your life, and then make a decision from there, okay?
Okay. Thanks.
All right. Okay, all right. Jason. Well, thank you so much for calling us, and good luck to you. I hope it works out.
Okay. Thank you.
All righty. Bye bye. Gosh, that's, I don't know, man. It really, emotional cheating for me is really worse
for
than...
For me as well. I mean, like, there was a guy I used to date before who was really flirtatious with other girls.
Mm-hmm.
And I would tell him, like, you know, it would seriously not mean anything to me if you fuck other girls. Because I know I'm hot naman eh, so like, whatevs. But like, if you love her more than me, then fuck off!
Yeah, seriously.
You know what I mean? That's the worst kind of cheating for me, honestly.
Exactly. I mean, because you can't win that back, you know? I mean, I'm not saying at all that physical cheating is not bad. It is terrible.
It is fucking terrible.
I think it's
well.
Awful. You know, having sex with someone else and breaking your girlfriend's heart or wife's heart or whoever it is an awful, awful thing. It really is. But emotional cheating, sex sometimes can be detached. Guys
yes,
do
yes.
tend to have
because
sex with
just,
women.
They're just guys. And it's more understandable for me.
You know, I wouldn't say understandable.
Yeah, more
but,
forgiving.
Well, society is not as harsh about men just
cheating.
Fucking other women, right?
Yes, that's I find that so
which
fucked
is kind of messed up. It is a messed up thing. You know, especially if girls, if your boyfriend is cheating on you all the time and having sex with loads of other women, I'm not telling you to stay with them at all. No, that is unforgivable and you should get out right now. Have some self-respect. But in cases such as people who have been together for 10 years or have kids together or married, you know, once in a while people do mess up and you know it's up to you completely whether or not you can change the situation if you want to get out or if you want to stay and try and work it out because people do make yeah. mistakes after a long time. It does tend to happen, so that depends on you whether or not you can deal with it, live with it, forgive the person and move on. But if it is emotional cheating, if it is the fact that the person has fallen in love with them and is no longer in love with you, it's a totally yeah. different story. Now, you can't win that back anymore. That's very, very difficult. And it might be fondness.
That would be more painful.
Yeah. And also, they might stay with you because of obligation, because they feel they don't want to hurt you. And, you know, you might feel bad afterwards. Yeah. But in the long run, I'd rather that a man let me go if he was in love with someone else. I'd
true.
Be like, you know what? Go and be with someone that you're meant to be with. Don't be with me just for the sake of
yes,
it. You know,
yes,
I don't
yes.
want to be your for the sake of it girl. Diba?
Yeah,
I want to be
yeah.
the love of your life.
For sure.
Diba?
Yeah.
So.
For sure.
Alrighty, we're going to go to our next call right now. Steve, who is 24 years old from Bulacan. Steve, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Hello.
Hi, how
Steve.
Are you, Steve?
I'm good.
That's
you
awesome.
Guys.
We're really good, actually. How are you doing? Are you good?
I'm great.
Good?
I'm great.
Good. Awesome.
I'm great.
Awesome. So, Steve, what can we do for you today?
I just have this little problem about my girlfriend. I have this problem with my girlfriend. It's kind of messed up. My question is, what would you do if everything is so messed up and you still want to make it up with her family?
What do you mean by so messed up? I think you have to be a little more specific about this.
I give you this situation about us. We're perfect. I think we're really perfect about our relationship. Nagkahulihan. Her Facebook account was left. Naiwan, naka-login lang. Tapos, syempre, we have this times na medyo hot kami, di ba? May mga times na, di ba, horny. Okay, maybe yun nga yung time na yun. So, may mga post, naka-post ng mga pictures. That's the only way na makakapag-communicate kami since medyo malayo kami sa isa't isa.
Wait, where is she?
So, she's from, actually, nasa Quezon City lang siya. Pero nasa Bulacan ako.
Okay.
Pero hindi kami makapagkita. So, ang nangyari, yung kuya niya, nakita yung account niya. So,
oh,
may nakita
what?
Mga sensitive
yung account
pictures.
Niya, yung mga sexy pictures
okay,
silang
okay,
dalawa.
Okay.
Super
uh-huh.
sexy.
Okay.
Super sexy pictures. So, medyo na-violate ko yung nararamdaman ng kuya niya. So, from that on, nagkaroon ng issues whatsoever. Ayaw na sa akin ng family. So,
wait, sexy pictures with issues. You or sexy pictures na siya lang?
Pasahan kami ng dalawa ng pictures. So,
De, pero picture yung pictures na nakita ng brother niya, siya lang ba? Sexy pictures na nakapost siya or kasama ka?
No, it's they pass pictures to each other of each other. So it's pictures of him.
Him and her.
Yeah.
Magkahiwalay kasi kami. Pasahan kami ng pictures. So picture ko, picture niya. So send.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah,
so,
yeah,
parang,
yeah. Pero may parang, nakita ba ng kapatid, nakita ng kuya niya yung edits mo? Ganun nangyari, pretty much, right?
Oo. Oh, oh.
Whoa!
Oh, hey, bakit yeah. Sa FB?
Oh, kuya!
Bro, ano ba naman yan?
Yeah.
Ganyan nangyayari ang mga scandal.
Sorry, kuya. Okay.
Yun nga. So, unexpectedly, parang nahuli nga kami. So, everything is all messed up na.
Okay. So, wait, pero bago nila nalaman yung, bago nila nakita yung pictures mo, legal na ba kayo sa bahay nila?
Alam na.
Gano'ng katagal na ba kayo? Like, they know you guys are sleeping together and all of that stuff, right?
Hmm. Alam naman. Pero, syempre, yun nga. Paano ko ba maayos yun? Kasi,
well, to be fair with you, I don't think na maayos yan with the kuya for a very long time kasi nakita niya yung picture ng edits mo. So, bro on bro, di ba? Parang, when you see another guy's dick, you don't really want to hang out with him
tapos
that much anymore.
You're dating
diba?
Pa the sister. So, pag nakikita niya kayo together, he's like, tanga na edits.
Diba?
So, it's like double thing na parang tanga na edits, lalaki ako, ayoko niyan. Tapos, ikaw pa yung boyfriend ng sister niyo. So, parang, yo.
Nagkahulihan nga talaga. So, you think there's no other chance?
Well, I don't know about the kuya, okay? The kuya, you might have a little bit of time that you need to wait before you try to approach him or anything like that. You might need to give him some space, okay? And let the scarring heal from his eyes. Pero, But for the rest of the family, I mean, sigurado naman they're conservative, diba? So if they're gonna hear something like that, they're gonna think you're a bad person because syempre, medyo old school sila. Mm-hmm. Ayaw nila nagaganunan kayo. They don't wanna know about it. It's a shame lang na nalaman nila kasi ngayon, syempre, alam nilang lahat. Alam nila kung anong kulay yung balls mo, ganon. Unfortunately for you, ang itim ng bayag niya. But
di pa siya natutuli. Puso pa pa yun?
Hindi ako.
Support! Ay, sorry. Ay, nako. No. But,
why are you laughing? Totoo na. Joke lang.
Support ka ba?
Nagulat niya ako eh. Napakao ko pero...
Nagulat ka na? Support ka ba?
Support ka ba? Support ka talaga?
Uy, hindi.
Oh! Uy, hindi ah. Uy, hindi ah. Tuloy na ako. I'm a big boy. Yeah. Alright. We're veering off the topic here. But you know what? With the parents, I think that you guys have been together for how long now? How many years na?
Actually, kaka-anniversary lang namin na 16.
Okay.
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
Nangyari yun mga 8 months. Mga 8 months, 7 months kami.
Oh.
So, diba?
Oh God, bago pa lang.
Medyo
raw pa yung scars ni kuya, bro.
Yes, medyo newborn pa yan, bro. Ay, nako, sayang talaga na nakita ng parents yung mga pictures ng edits mo at 7 or 8 months. Ano?
Everything is so perfect naman kasi talagang maayos naman. Unexpectedly, nagkaroon na ng horny time tapos ganun pa.
May horny time naman talaga palagi pag umpisa pa lang, diba?
No. Okay, you
actually,
know what? What happened is your fault, Steve. What happened is not your fault. You shouldn't blame yourself. It happens sometimes that accidentally your parents will find things that you're not supposed to let them see, especially if it's your naked body. But, you know, I think the only thing that you can really do is give it some time. I mean, you don't see them naman eh. So it shouldn't really affect you unless they're telling their daughter not to be with you na. Is that your problem? Na sinasabi nila sa kanya na dapat breakan ka na ng anak nila. Is that your problem?
Actually, nagbibigay na sila na ng ano, ng senyales na talaga na to break it up about that issue. So, yun.
So they're telling her to break up with you.
Oh, that's why I'm so... messed up na talaga man. Gusto ko ayusin kasi ayokong ganun yung image ko sa kanila tapos ganun pa nangyari.
Well, you know what? Actually, Steve, in this situation then, because you are not there to defend yourself, diba? Your girlfriend will actually have to take on more of this role with her parents. She That's will have true. To be the one who tells her parents, diba? Because no matter what, if the parents hear from their daughter that their boyfriend makes them happy, right?
Yes. I mean, I'm sure it that your parents... It makes a big difference. It's more of her responsibility na than yours, eh.
Yeah.
Kasi, diba? Syempre, siya yung nakikita nila. And, hello, she's the daughter.
Yeah.
So, at the end of the day, it's more of up to how much she will defend you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
She really needs to defend you to them and say that, you know what, we're together. I love him. We're very, very happy. He makes me very happy. And this is a very natural thing for couples to do. I know that it's hard for Filipinos to say this to their parents. Kasi kahit ako, daddy ko is Pinoy, diba? So alam ko yung mga topics na sex or nude pictures is a very hard thing to tell them. Yes, I don't ever talk to my dad about this stuff. But unfortunately, in your girlfriend's case, she's gonna have to be, you know, kind of open about it with her parents and say, you know, he makes me really happy, and she has to defend you to them. Otherwise, there's no chance really of you getting back in the good books with them unless, you know, pupunta ka dun, tapos mama kaawa ka, ganun, like, and bring food and be the really nice guy all the time. Pero mahirap din yun kasi if you're in that situation na hindi ka naman binaback up ng girlfriend mo, ibig sabihin nandun ka lang, tapos kung bad trip silang lahat sa'yo, awkward ka lang, diba? OP ka lang dun, nakaupo ka lang, may dala kang lechon, yun pala, vegetarian silang lahat, right? It's kind of that kind of vibe to it. So, I don't know, you really have to talk to your girlfriend about it and ask her how she feels about it. I'm sure naman you don't have problems apart from this, no? You guys are happy, you guys want to stay together, right?
Yeah, everything is perfect talaga.
Well, there you go, then you want to get married?
Not yet, pero syempre. She's younger, eh. So she's 18, I'm 24.
Oh,
so.
Oh, that makes a big difference, yo! Yo!
Okay.
Ilan taon na si kuya kaedad mo ba?
Steve!
How old is kuya?
Mm.
How old yung kuya niya?
Older, 1 year older.
Than you?
Than you or than her?
Hello? Oh, she's 1 year older than you or than your girlfriend? Mm. 1 year older than you.
19 yung...
Ah, 19 yung brother niya. Steve, I'm gonna tell you right now, swerte ka, hindi ka pa binabaril ng kuya niya, okay? He is a young guy with a lot of hormones.
Hormones going on.
You are banging his 18-year-old baby sister, bro. This is dangerous in the Philippines. You should know this by now. Oh, my goodness. And how you guys have been seeing each other for 7 months, which means she's probably a very young 18-year-old or... turning 19 soon, which is very young. Okay, so shit, man. I don't blame Kuya for being kind of pissed off at you and her whole family because they don't want to know that their baby girl is having sex at the age of 18.
And
nobody.
Posting pictures on the internet, for that matter.
Yeah, nobody wants to know. Because in their eyes, what's a sagwa? Masagwa ba yan? Is that the right term? Or what's
masagwa
the
is like pangit or like off.
Okay,
it's
what's
more
that?
Like,
what's that word that they have? That they don't want to know that their girlfriend is kind of loose, you know? That she's sending slutty pictures to her boyfriend and she's having sex. I mean, not that she's a slut. I'm not saying that at all. You guys want to have sex, that's your prerogative, okay?
But it's
not
that. First thought that comes to family members when the girl's that young.
Exactly. In the Philippines, any family member who finds out that their daughter is having sex is going to turn the other way and say, you didn't just say that to me. It's not true. She's still a virgin. She's going to be a virgin until she's married. She's a virgin. Don't talk to me anymore.
Why do I see her balls? She's still a virgin. Why are you showing her balls? Are you trying to make her open her legs? She's not going to open her legs. She's still a virgin.
Yeah, you know.
Stuff
so
like that, diba?
In their eyes, ikaw yung BI.
Mm-hmm.
You know, was she a virgin when you met her?
No. She's been...
But they don't know that. They don't know that and they will never, ever, ever think that it's like that. The point that they saw your freaking balls on the internet will make them think that you're like... either trying to divergenize her or have already divergenized her. And for me, I think it's more like they think that you're trying to divergenize her.
Yeah.
I mean, they will never ever think that she has anything to do with the fact that you're sending pictures. They will always think that you're influencing her into sending these pictures. They will think that you're the one who's asking her to send her these pictures because she's the young one. Hello, 19 years old lang yung kuya niya. Kuya na to, ah. So, pang tingin niya sa kapatid niya, bata, baby, ganyan. Tapos yung BF niya, ikaw, boyfriend niya, 24. Tapos yung etis niya, nandun pa sa harap ng mukha niya, diba? So, talagang, what the
grabe,
fuck is this shit?
Grabe.
Yung kuya na parang, tanga na, nung gagawin ko, 24, ano ba naman? Diba? Even he's getting really bothered about this shit, right?
Yeah, so...
He's confused as well.
Yeah, you know, this whole situation really kind of sucks for you right now. And I don't really know how to help you because in the Filipino family, this is really bad, okay? The fact that their daughter is having sex, number one, yung baby nila is having sex, is freaking them out. Plus, you're 24, it's freaking them out even more. Plus, you don't see her a lot, which is freaking them out even more because they're like, baka babaero yan, baka naman ang dami ng girlfriend, baka naman ganyan. So... You need to take a little bit of time. You need to let it cool off first, and you need to talk to your girlfriend about it. She needs to tell her parents that she's happy with you, that you guys are happy, you're in a long-term relationship, you're not going anywhere, you're not babaero and all of this stuff. And then when you can go over there, the earliest that you can go over there, probably in a few months, right? Something like that. Or would it be better for him to go earlier to show kind of like a show of faith that he's kind of being responsible about it? What do you think?
Maybe a bit earlier.
Yeah?
Possibly.
Yeah. Maybe go over there, magdala ka ng pansit or something, and
magpakita
you know,
ka para hindi lang yung edad silang maalala nila,
diba? Yeah, diba? Magpakita, magpakita
ka
na, ano?
Show them that you're actually a person and not just a cock.
Yeah.
Nagtempuhan talaga kami.
You know what I mean?
Nagtempuhan talaga.
Yeah. And also, you know what? You have to prove to them that you're a decent guy. So if you put up with their crap, if they give you shit, let them give you shit.
Because technically, in their eyes, you deserve the shit.
Yeah.
You know, don't be so, all like, fuck this, it's not what I meant. And but just take it a bit. If this girl really means that much to you, just take it a bit. And, you know, like Kat said, bring them a bit of food. Show them that you're a real person, diba?
Show them that you're a decent guy and you're not just some maniacs who's having sex with their daughter, okay?
Pretty much. 18-year-old daughter.
All right, Steve, good luck to you and try not to bang a minor next time, all right?
All right. Thank you.
See you soon, okay? Thanks. All right, guys, we got to go into a commercial break right now, but me and Max will be right back after this.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
It was a very memorable experience namin dalawa kasi plano namin, simple wedding lang, pero yung kinalabasan niya, extraordinary one.
Kinagabihan pala ng wedding namin, August 7, grabe na talaga yung ulan nun.
Yung mga attend ng kasal namin kasi nanghihingi sila ng confirmation kung tutuloy ba namin yung kasal kasi sobrang taas na din ng tubig. Pati yung photographer po kasi tinatanong kung tuloy ba namin yung kasal kasi medyo may tubig pa. Ang dami na namin nare-receive na calls, pati kami dalawa nagtatawagan.
Pero ang nire-reply namin sa kanila, tuloy talaga ang kasal kahit na ano mangyari. Buti na nga lang kamo, nakapag-register na kami agad nun. Kinagabihan pa lang ng...
Naka-only na kami parehas.
Naka-all-knit na kami, combo ng blue.
Kaya hindi masyadong hassle. Pag-text namin, pagtatawagan sa ibang naming mga kasali sa kasal.
Pagpasok ko ng dohasibahan, baka parang...
Hindi ko alam na nag-march pala lahat ng entourage ko sa ano, sa tubig.
Bago po kami lumabas ng simbahan, sinalubong po kami ng mga tao na nakakita sa amin. Talagang na-amaze sila, nagulat sila. Kaya yung nag-request sila ng ano doon, ng kiss.
Pero talagang tama yung sinabi ni Father na for better or for worse, through thick or thin.
Through text and calls.
Tama, natuloy din yung kasal namin. We're glad to be globe.
Hey, podcasters, Mo here. You ever watch the podcast, right? And you're sitting there and you're looking at our female celebrity guest and you're looking at her skin and you're like, wow, I'd love to have that complexion. Well, your answer is this. Glutamax, the official skin whitening partner of Miss Earth International. Available in capsules, soaps, lotion, deodorant, and face cream. Bikutis Mayaman with Glutamax. It's available in leading drugstores and supermarkets nationwide. Podcasters, listen up. Big announcement. The Chevrolet Sonic is a dependable 5-seater subcompact vehicle, and it delivers sufficient power, fuel efficiency, refined ride and handling, and a remarkable entertainment system. The Sonic is the perfect Chevrolet vehicle for those who are looking to make their daily city commute or weekend getaway drives more fun and exciting. It comes in two great body styles, the 5-door hatchback and a 4-door sedan. Equipped with a new 1.4-liter Ecotec engine with double continuous variable cam phase, that's CVC, the Chevy Sonic provides efficient power and quality driving performance. Now, to further highlight the youthful, sporty, and fun characteristics of the Sonic, Chevrolet has equipped the compact sedan with high-tech convenient features such as Bluetooth connectivity and audio streaming capabilities that are commonly found only on high-trim compact sedans. The Chevrolet Sonic is available at all Chevrolet dealers. It comes with a Chevrolet 5-year warranty, 3-year free roadside assistance, and the services of a 24/7 Chevy hotline.
What you've been missing on The Factory.
Were you the one who posted, James, regarding the guidelines when it comes to checkpoints?
Yes, I
That's
was.
That's fantastic.
Yes, I just made it up, but you know, I thought it was...
You made it up?
I mean, this time of year, right? Elections. You know,
know, you never let the truth get in the way of a good story, okay? Children, do not follow this at home. I'm just kidding. Just so you know your rights, if you do get stopped by a checkpoint,
you are not allowed we're able to verify all of these,
James. You're not allowed to run over them. That didn't make it here. So technically... Now, number two. Upon approach, slow down. I guess that counts as not running them over. Dim headlights and turn on cabin lights. Okay.
Cabin lights.
Mm-hmm. Lock all doors of vehicles during inspection.
Since lock?
Lock.
They might get pissed off because nope. you're locking
But that's doors. The thing. Okay. This is where they get you. And this is actually, I know we're making fun of it a little bit, but yeah. this is a serious issue. We've seen some people genuinely harassed. Drugs are planted.
Yeah.
And other things, stories. You know. A Justin Bieber CD is planted, which is even worse.
Oh, yes, no.
I've heard of that, you know. And there's no defense for that. There's
Bieber
really no defense. Yeah, it's like, but Your Honor, we found this. I throw the book at him. The then CD as well.
Then after that, you have to submit your cell phone and everything. Yeah. And next thing you know, you have a Justin Bieber ringtone.
Catch James Deacon and the Boys on Counterflow, Wednesdays, 7:30 to 8:30, only here. On the Factory.
Hi, everybody. I'm Bianca Valerio.
I'm Julia Snigowski.
I'm Trisha Santanera.
And we are the girls of 20. Yay!
Okay, so you have to be wondering what on earth is 20?
Exactly. So find out every Sunday night, 8:09. Hang out with us. Mm-hmm. We're going to be talking about everything under the sun.
Girls, boys,
boobs, boobs.
Okay, boobs, boobs. You say boobs. Eventually, the phone number will come.
But since in the meantime, we can't figure out the whole podcasting figure yeah. spot, but we're trying to figure out voice, figure
we need to get ourselves out, so we know what's going on.
Exactly. Okay, anyway, our first podcast is this Sunday at 8.
Yeah.
Please join us because we're all here.
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
All right, guys, we're back here on the Good Times with Mo podcast. I'm Kat Alano taking over for Mo this evening, and with me is the lovely Max Eigenmann.
Hello.
Now, guys, if you're going to Boracay this summer, you should check out Globe's first ever concept store in Boracay at D Mall. Sounds cool to me. You can open an account if you haven't yet. You can update your account if you already have one, pay your bills, or get a copy of your bill, or even check out and buy phones and gadgets there. So let's just say you got so buzzed that you lost your phone. At least you can easily grab a phone from the new concept store that happens in Boracay a lot. So now that they have 172 stores nationwide, that is just the start. Globe makes sure that they are closer to you when you need it. It is a cool shop. And if you're in Boracay, go and check it out right now. Well, maybe not right now, but, you know, when you have time.
When you have time.
Yeah. We're not saying leave and stop watching us because we like to have you with us. So now, Max, you know what? I wanted to ask you this while I have you here with me. Being from a very showbiz family, if that's okay, I can say you're the showbiz sure. family, right?
Yeah.
That's what I didn't say. You know, being in relationships, I mean, I'm sure that for you, it must have been really difficult to have boyfriends because I'm sure that it comes with that whole, you're an Eigenmann yeah. thing and yeah. they want to date you because you're beautiful and you're hot and you're artista and they don't necessarily want to date you because of who you really are. You know what I mean? So yeah. how, you know, tell us some of your experiences with dating people having been
well,
like this.
Actually, now I'm pretty lucky to say that my boyfriend at the moment mm-hmm. is really, really supportive with my work, but I have Quento about this. I like this.
Yeah, yeah.
There was this guy that I used to date before. Mm-hmm. And it was during the time when I was still starting out in showbiz. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we were actually kind of playing house for a while and stuff like that. And after a while, when he noticed that I was coming home much later, because when we tape, we come home, we work for 24 hours
yeah,
straight.
Yeah.
Sometimes, you know, sometimes you work just for 2 hours and blah, blah, blah. But most of the time we work for hours on end,
yeah.
right? And
sometimes even longer than 24 hours.
And because of the fact that, syempre, diba, with the work, it comes with like love teams
yeah.
or like people mm-hmm. that you're paired up with on screen, whether it's a movie or a soap or whatever and stuff like that. And this particular guy that I was dating really, really found it difficult to accept the fact that the job came with that.
Yeah, yeah.
And there was this one time where he was just like, you better quit your job. You know, you're prostituting yourself.
Oh,
and I was
gosh.
Just like, I was like, excuse me, what? Well, you get paid
to kiss boys. You're prostituting yourself. And, you know, and for me, that's when I actually realized that this guy was not for me.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I was much younger. I mean, I'm only 25 now.
Yeah.
And this was like years ago. And I realized that, parang, okay, this is who I am.
Yeah.
You know, I'm starting to find myself. And this is, first of all, this is my family thing. You already knew that I was probably going to end up doing this. Although I wasn't entering the business yet.
Yeah.
When we met. But it was like, what the fuck, Debop? Yeah. Prostituting myself?
Yeah, you know, people have this problem all the time, actually. You know, they see the showbiz thing as very glitzy and glamour, and they don't actually realize about the actual nitty-gritty that goes into it. If you want to watch a romantic movie with somebody making out, somebody has to make out with somebody for you to see in the movie, right? So, you know, I always tell people, like, I've even said to people, like, if I'm going to date them, you know, I'm like, you have to understand that my job comes with certain things that I have to do. And if you're uncomfortable with it, we can talk about it. And I'll always be supportive afterwards if you want to talk to me about it or if you have
but don't give me shit about it.
Yeah. Don't give me hell about my work because you're already aware of the fact that this is what I do for a living. And I would never ask you not to do something in your job. Okay, fair enough. It's not kissing other people. But you already knew this about me. So tanggap mo o hindi mo tanggap. Yeah. Like, that's
alam
pretty
mo na,
much
yun,
it.
Alam mo na eh. Diba? Parang bakit?
But galit
when it's
ka
there
pa.
Now. But oh, sige, oh, yeah, oh my God, have a good day at work. And you know already what it's in the script, blah, 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 blah. And then, you know, when you come home and then you realize while I'm gone, because you missed me so much, and you realize, oh fuck, I just had her to work and she's going to be like holding hands with some boy or whatnot, and you're going to give me shit when I get home.
Yeah.
I mean, what the hell, diba?
Yeah. Kung seloso ka, don't date an artista. It's pretty much the simplest thing, you know?
Fuck, man.
Yeah, if you have trust issues, you can't do it. You know, if you can't handle that, then you can't
be
with somebody.
Don't date somebody from the biz.
Yeah, just don't do it. Anyway, I ask you that because, you know, people always assume that we have, like, awesome lives and people who are in showbiz,
you
know,
stress,
have
you know?
Romances that are like sparkles and flowers and romance and helicopter rides.
We're also people.
Yeah.
Right? People think that we're, like, living, like, oh my God, I want to be like, we're, like, living the lives and we're so, but, you know, it comes with stress as well. Mm-hmm. We're normal people. We have the same shit that everybody else goes through, which is why we're capable of answering these questions, by the way.
Exactly.
Why we're capable of, you know, like fixing your shit, you guys. I mean, because we go through the same shit.
Yeah.
As
and actually,
else.
You know, I think that one thing that people don't realize about artistas is that when you date someone, they usually have a different image of what you really are, and they have that in their mind, and they expect you to be something that they saw on TV when you're really
never
gonna
be
that.
And by the way, people artists who actually date, they also have sex, you know.
Yeah.
They're not gonna be, you know, because like, oh my God, she kissed that boy, blah 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 blah.
Yeah, yeah.
We're tao din kami, you guys. Come
tao
on.
Lang, tao lang.
Pero pareho lang tayo, diba? Yo.
We have the same bits, man.
Yeah, dude. I mean, this is a job just like any other job.
Yeah, exactly. I always say that, you know, doing showbiz stuff is my job. It's not, you know, who I am as a person, you know?
I totally get you.
Right? It shouldn't define you. But anyway, this is why Max is here to answer calls with me today, because she's awesome and she's been through a lot of stuff in her life like me. So we have another caller right here right now. If you want to call us up, guys, the number again is 478-7954 or 0927-360-0485. We have James, our caller, who is 20 years old from Caloocan on the line. James, are you there?
Yes.
Hi, James. How
Hi,
are
James.
You?
Hi, James.
Hi, I'm okay. Here's my question.
Okay.
Right now, I'm feeling needy about my girlfriend, about my relationship.
You're feeling
my
what?
Girlfriend, needy.
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 Ah, okay.
In what way?
It doesn't bother my girlfriend, but for me, I feel bothered about it. I'm a little bit anxious about it.
Okay.
Is this a bad thing? Or I have a trust issue?
Okay, what do you mean exactly by needy? Like, I mean, are you calling her every second and like, where are you? Who are you with? What are you wearing? Why are you not here? You know, I mean, what's needy?
If she doesn't text around an hour or 30 minutes, I call her.
Okay.
Parang ganun. But it doesn't bother her.
Okay.
Pero for me, parang inuubusan ko siya ng space. Pero okay. Ayoko naman dumating sa part na sabihin niya sa akin na masyado na ako needy.
Oh, so you're catching yourself like right now na parang hindi mo nagugustuhan yung fact na palagi kong tumatawag pag ganyan.
Mm-hmm.
So you're having issues with yourself.
Yes. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. So what is it really that you're worried about? Pag hindi na nagte-text o tumatawag yung girlfriend mo after 30 minutes or 1 hour, what is it that goes through your mind? Nagpapanik ka ba? May nangyari sa kanya? Or iniisip mo ba na may kasama siyang iba?
Siguro trust issue.
Trust issue.
So,
na ano?
So yun nga, iniisip mo nga na baka may kasama siyang iba. So parang you're trying to... You're trying to fill in the lost hours that she's not replying in your head. That's why you're calling.
Maybe she's like, medyo napapaan nga minsan naisip ko ba may ka-text siyang iba or something. And it really bothers me.
Wait, have you had a relationship in the past where you've been cheated on or you've been cheated on before?
Actually, that explains it.
Actually, I was the one who cheated.
Oh, okay. So, may trust issues ka kasi babaero ka. So, alam mo kung paano mag-cheat. So, iniisip mo ngayon na...
Yun yung, na baka yun ang ginagawa ng current girlfriend mo kasi alam mo kung paano ginagawa yun.
Oh, kumbaga nakaano kong katapat mo ngayon eh.
So, kumbaga ngayon, nanloko ka ng babae. Ngayon, takot ka na maloloko ka kasi in love ka sa babae.
Yep.
Takot ka makakarmahin ka, ganon. Okay, so, ang problema dito, James, is do you feel like your girlfriend is actually genuinely cheating on you?
No, right now. Wala pa namang early sign.
No, so you don't think that there's any signs. Huh, James, the thing is, you're young, okay? You're 20 years old, you're young, and I can understand that you'd want to sleep around a little bit if you're a guy at this age. But why are you in a long-term relationship now? You really love this girl? Sigurado ka ba? You want to be in a relationship?
Actually, 50-50 because mag-abroad na rin ako eh.
So hindi mo rin alam. So... Ang talagang nangyayari dito is hindi mo iniisip na may ibang kasama yung girlfriend mo. Ang iniisip mo kasi may doubts ka na, nagdududa ka na sa relationship nyo.
Yep.
So ikaw yung nag-iisip kung gusto mo mag-cheat o hindi. That's what's happening right now, isn't it?
No, hindi ko na iniisip na mag-cheat eh. Iniisip ko kung mag-stay ako kasi if nasa logic ko is kung patatagalin for fixing, patatagalin ko po o tapusin na lang kagad.
Wait, so you're scared that she's gonna cheat on you, so you wanna end it now?
Yep.
That's the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
Me too, man.
Okay, that's really dumb. All right, that's really dumb. James, listen to me. Number one, if you're in a relationship with someone, like we were saying earlier with the guy who thought that, you know, he was scared about his boyfriend dying because he's older than him, okay? In life, there are things that you cannot change. This is what everybody gets so freaked out about. They try to control everything. They try to hold on so tightly to every aspect
kind of, like,
of their
they
lives.
They kind of stress about the things that hasn't even happened.
Yeah.
Diba?
You know, you can't control everything in your life. Let's say tomorrow, I mean, God forbid, but what if she ends up in the hospital? Or what if she breaks up with you? Or what if she, you know, ends up, I don't know, what else could happen? What is another
what
scenario?
What if she ends up sleeping with your dad? Like the other
father. What if she ends up sleeping with your dad? You know, all of these things, if she cheats on you, okay? Now, you need to let go of this issue because ikaw naman talaga yung cheater eh. I've seen this happen before though. Cheaters, they... get
fear
paranoid.
What they do. They
exactly.
Get paranoid to be treated the way they're being. They treat other people.
Yeah.
It's pretty fucked up because you're kind of stressing over something that you think she might do because you're capable of doing that. Maybe you're just afraid of the fact that you might do it to her and you're trying to. Parang gusto mo lang maging patas. Kaya you're trying to like. Kasi yung iniisip mo pala, ikaw pala yung gusto mga liwa.
No. I think what's happening kasi dito is I understand what you mean. I understand what you mean, but I think in this case, is na in love siya, and takot siya, nakakarmahin siya, mangyayari sa kanya yung ginawa niya. So, you know what, James, you can't spend all this time worrying about whether or not your girlfriend is gonna cheat on you. If she answers your calls diligently, if she doesn't mind that you're needy, and she's always there for you, if she's never shown you any signs, diba? If she's never shown you any signs of straying or being a cheater, then you can't worry about these things because anong gagawin mo for the rest of your life? Selos ka? Worried ka? Paranoid ka? Diba? Hindi man pwedeng ganun na araw-araw freaked out ka. Ang sad naman ng buhay mo kung ganun. Diba? You have to let go of stuff. Enjoy. Why do people get into relationships and then freak out about everything bad that could ever possibly go wrong? You want to have a relationship with somebody because it's amazing and you have fun and you have a good time. And when the bad things happen, you get through the bad things together. Not the other way around. You don't live together and then freak out about every little thing until something good happens. It's not like that there. No, you need to just forget about it. You know, if she's going to cheat on you, you know what? You kind of deserve it, bro, if you cheated on somebody else. Sorry, but you kind of do. But, you know, you can't control that. If you love her, then love her talaga. Don't cheat. Don't be a fucker.
And don't stress.
Yeah, and don't think about it too much. If she's going to cheat on you, she's going to cheat on you. But if she's solid to you, don't. Alam mo yun, kasi ako, ayoko kasi ng seloso eh. Ako, nahihirapan ako sa seloso. Because I'm a very loyal person, alright? And I have done nothing wrong for you to be selos. You know, I understand that people have, sometimes they're just selosos.
Yeah, because seloso guys kind of stress you out and push you away a bit.
Yeah. No, but that's what I'm saying is that when a guy is seloso and you've given him no reason to be selos, right? It pushes the girl away because you're not even doing anything and you're already giving me shit. So, I should do shit na lang, di ba? Because you're already giving me the shit for something that I haven't even done to you yet. So, pucha, mag-cheat na lang talaga ako.
So you're kind of, technically, you're provoking her.
Yeah.
Di ba? You're kind of pushing her to the edge and, di ba? So,
and you're pushing her away. I mean, yes. She didn't do anything to deserve you doubting her. She doesn't deserve your doubt. So, kailangan pag nasa relationship ka, may tiwala ka o wala kang relationship talaga. Pag walang tiwala ang relationship mo, you don't have a relationship at all. And you're just gonna be freaked out the whole time. But whether or not, she's gonna cheat on you. And that's not a relationship.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes, thank you.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, and don't cheat anymore. If you don't want to be with somebody, break up with them. Okay?
All right. Thank you.
All right, James. Thank you so much for calling us up.
Thank you.
All right. Hoogly dokly. Do you have anybody else on the line right now? Yes? No? Okay, 2 more minutes for somebody. So let's talk some more about you. What have you been doing recently? What is being a mom like? Tell me about being
awesome,
a mother.
Man.
Yeah?
Yeah. Especially to my 2 boys. They're the sweetest things on earth.
Yeah.
Every day they remind me how awesome life is.
Okay.
And it's really cool picture. I mean, seeing life through their eyes, you know, like, cause I actually just Instagrammed the other day I tweeted the other day that I love my kids as well as acting like one. So it's extra fun to have my kids because I'm such a big kid.
Yeah.
So like it's beautiful.
But also, you know what? I want to ask you this because you got pregnant young, right? You had 17. Kids young. You were 17 years old when you had your first kid. Wow. Yeah. So, there are a lot of people out there who are probably, you know, in the same situation as you, single mother and all that. Mm-hmm. What was that like for you? I mean, especially being in showbiz and everything, and everybody knows what's going on in your life and that you're a single mom and all of this. I mean, what was it like for you?
At the time when I had my first kid, I wasn't in showbiz yet.
Okay.
I entered after.
Yeah, yeah.
But the hardest part for me, I guess, was actually telling my parents.
Yeah.
You know, but at the same time when I did, and I decided to do it early on, it was the biggest relief.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, if ever any of you have the same situation, like out there watching.
I know there are a lot of you.
A lot of you must be going through the same thing as I did at the time. It would be the best thing the best decision you would ever make is to tell your parents right away.
Yeah.
Because your family, no matter how much you think it's not going to be that way, but your family will be the people who will most definitely stick with you.
Yeah.
At the situation like that.
Unless they disown you, in which case, we're sorry we gave you that advice. Please, we retract it now. But in most cases, your family will be the one that sticks by you in this kind of thing.
Yes,
you know?
Yes, for sure.
So, yeah. But yeah, for everybody out there who has the same situation.
And it's a relief,
because,
for those people who actually are going through or went through the same situation as I did, the biggest fear that comes through the minds of young people is that, oh my God, how the hell am I going to tell my parents? That's the number one thing, but it's actually the biggest relief. It'll make you go through the whole thing more comfortably.
Yeah.
Even if they take it wrong, even if they take it badly or if they take it good, at the same time, whether or not they take it the way you would like them, the fact is you told them not, and it's a relief.
Yeah. Yeah. And then you don't have to hide it for the next 9 months,
yes,
right?
Exactly.
I mean, that's the most difficult thing.
Which is how much harder to do than to just say it.
My cousin was lucky when she was 17. She was kind of fat because she got to 7 or 8 months. She got to 7 or 8 months and then she told her parents. But, you know, that's only if you're fat. You know, you can't really do that if you're not. So anyway, thank you for sharing that, though. I know that for some people it's a very personal thing. But, you know, I think it's always good for us to share our own experiences with people out there and let them know that we're human and that we go through these things and we can understand them going through it as well, you know? So we're going to go into another commercial break right now, but when we come back, we're going to pick our caller of the night. Stay tuned.
Stay tuned. We'll return after this commercial break.
stars, we're always on the move. It's really important for us to get better and stronger for every competition that we get into. For all the different lifestyles that we have, some of us are graphic artists, filmmakers, we still find ways to get together. We put a lot of effort in practicing and rehearsing. Minsan may mga biglaang shows or auditions, so it's really important for us to get connected. I use my Globe group messaging to get a hold of everybody else. Malayo na rin ang narating namin, marami na rin kaming napuntahan. So it's really important to get connected.
What you've been missing on the factory.
Were you the one who posted, James, regarding the guidelines when it comes to checkpoints?
Yes, I
That's
was.
That's fantastic.
Yes, I just made it up, but you know, I thought it was.
I mean,
this time of year, right? Elections. You know, you never let the truth get in the way of a good story, okay? Children, do not follow this at home. I'm just kidding. Just so you know your rights, if you do get stopped by a checkpoint,
you are not allowed
we're able to verify all of these, James.
You're not allowed to run over them. That didn't make it here. So technically. Now, number two, upon approach, slow down. I guess that counts as not running them over. Dim headlights and slow turn down. On cabin lights. Okay?
Cabin lights. Mm-hmm.
Lock all doors of vehicles during inspection.
Since lock?
Lock.
They might get pissed off because you're locking
But that's
doors.
The thing. Okay. This is where they get you. And this is actually, I know we're making fun of it a little bit, but yes. This is a serious issue. We've seen some people genuinely harassed. Drugs are planted.
And
other things,
stores.
You know. A Justin Bieber CD is planted, which is even worse.
Oh,
yes,
no.
I've heard of that, you know. And there's no defense for that. There's
Bieber
really no defense. Yeah, it's like, but Your Honor, we found this. throw the book at him. The
then
CD as well.
Then after that, you have to submit your cell phone and everything. Yeah. And next thing you know, you have a Justin Bieber ringtone.
Catch James Deacon and the Boys on Counterflow, Wednesday, 7:30 to 8:30, only here. On the factory.
Hey, podcasters, Mo here. You ever watch the podcast, right? And you're sitting there and you're looking at our female celebrity guest and you're looking at her skin and you're like, wow, I'd love to have that complexion. Well, your answer is this. Glutamax, the official skin whitening partner of Miss Earth International. Available in capsules, soaps, lotion, deodorant, and face cream. Bikutis Mayaman with Glutamax. It's available in leading drugstores and supermarkets nationwide. Hey, Mo Twister here. All right, podcasters, listen up, because this is really, really important. Major Homes brings you unique and creative developments, giving you a real chance at a sure, affordable, and hassle-free investment. Invest in your future today. Call 0917-517-4287. Major Homes is here.
Take a little sunshine.
And we are the girls of 20. Okay, so you have to be wondering what on earth is 20?
Exactly, so find out every Sunday night, 8-9. Hang out with us.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna be talking about everything under the sun.
Girls, boys,
goobs, goobs.
Okay,
goobs,
fine.
What
you say, goobs?
We want to talk to you guys too.
Yeah. Eventually, the phone number will come.
But since in the meantime, we can't figure out the whole podcast thing, out, but we're trying to figure out voice, figure
we
out.
We can make it ourselves out, so we know what's going on.
Exactly.
Okay.
Anyway, our first podcast is this Sunday at 8.
Yeah.
Please join us because we're all here.
My girlfriend says she hates me.
It's Good Times with Mo, the podcast. Call the show tonight and get your love problem answered.
Follow us on Twitter at GTWM Podcast.
And visit www.motwister.com.
All right, we're back here on the Good Times with Mo podcast. Subbing in for Mo today is me, Kat Alano, and of course, the beautiful Max Eigenmann with me as well. Guys, it has come to the end of the show, so it is time for us to pick the caller of the night. And today, Max, do you want to announce who we decided would be our caller of the night?
I decided on... I forgot his name, though. John, right? Okay, John, the one with a boyfriend, with a 50-year-old boyfriend.
With the 52-year-old boyfriend. We think you're sweet, and we think that it's sweet that you have your gay man and that you want to stick it out with him and that you were worried about him and everything. So we made you our winner of the night. Do we have him on the line?
Hello.
Hi, John.
Hi.
Hi, congratulations to you. Your sweet little gay story made us love you, and now we want to...
You're the caller of the night.
Yeah, you're the caller of the night. Congratulations. We want to know, which one of the three baggies do you want? One, two, or three?
Three.
Three?
Okay.
All righty, Max, what is in bag number three?
What is in store for you, darling. It's a globe tattoo stick.
A globe tattoo stick. So if you ever go abroad, you can chat with your lover, you know, with your globe tattoo stick. Congratulations, John.
Yeah, thank you.
You're very welcome. And good luck with your man, okay? I hope that it lasts for you guys and that it's wonderful and you have loads of awesome sex, okay?
Okay.
All righty. Take care. Bye-bye. All right, you guys. Now, Max, is there anything else you want to tell everybody before we sign off the air?
I love Kat Alano.
Oh, thank you. I love you, too. You're so the sweetest. You're so awesome. We're going out after this.
All right.
We're already doing that. All right, guys. If you want to check out Max, you can follow her on Twitter. Of course, her Twitter name has been flashing up all night. It's Max Eigenmann, which is very simple. Of course, you can follow me on Twitter as well. It's Kat Alano. Also, at the beginning of the show, guys, we were playing a song just before the last song, and it was called Shades of Blue, and that's actually the new song of my band, Decibel. With an L-E at the end, D-E-C-I-B-E-L-L-E. So if you guys want to check that out, our Twitter name is DecibelPH. And if you like our songs, please do go on YouTube, watch them, like them, share them with your friends and all that stuff, okay? We want to say thank you to Granny's Burger. And yay, their number is 576-3998. I'd also like to say thank you to She Loves It Shop on Instagram, who gave me my awesome blue eyes today. I have awesome blue eyes. Can you see?
They're hot.
Yeah. Blue eyes. Anyway, I want to say thank you to them. And also thank you to everyone who called us up tonight, everybody who texted and everything. Thank you so much, Max, for joining me.
I had a really wonderful time
with you.
It's my second time here, and it's always a blast.
I had a wonderful time with you, and thank you for giving everyone such wonderful advice. You know, I don't think they could survive without us sometimes. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching. I will be back here tomorrow with Bianca Valerio, I believe, who will be my guest tomorrow. So I'll see you guys then. Thank you so much. And anybody else you want to say bye to?
Good night, everyone.
Bye. Good night, guys.
Good Times with Mo, the podcast, was executively produced by Mohan Gumata, engineered by Miguel Alfindo, and operated by Icon Media Inc.
Special thanks to Magic 89.9. You can follow Mo on Twitter at www.twitter.com/DJMoTwister.
Email him at goodtimeswithmopodcast@rocketmail.com.